The Beast is asking, has Venezuelan President Maduro gone insane? We'll give you the latest from the socialist paradise of Venezuela here a little bit later on. And, of course, you can join us in here toll-free at 855-450-FREE. Maybe you want to comment on Venezuela or tag being banned. And that is where, Mark, you're going to start us tonight. I think we teased this last night. We never got to it. Tag, the game, the classic kids game that probably everyone within the sound of our voices has played at some point in their life and survived, miraculously survived the playing of the tag game. But apparently some are saying that it is dangerous, and so it needs to be stopped. Mark, where's the story coming from?
This is from Huffington Post under their weird news section. And I don't consider this weird news. I consider this to be the, well, the reasonable outcome of our litigious society, the desire of some to sort of round the sharp corners of life to make things safer and better. Because if you ask people, if you go around the street and ask people, do you think we should have, our schools should be safer for children? Like, something like 90-something percent of people are going to say, yes, schools should be safer for children.
Yeah, who doesn't want their kids to be safe?
At which point, any proposal that anybody makes to make schools safer is a proposal that should be considered as a strong possibility, right? So, how many kids are hurt playing tag every year? I don't know the answer, but I would imagine it's more now than it used to be because we used to play football at school. We weren't allowed to play tackle. We had to play a two-hand touch, but I believe there was some tackling that might have gone on.
Mm-hmm.
And now I would just guess, this is just me guessing, that 30-something years later, kids aren't allowed to play football at school unless they're playing with helmets and pads and these the sort of, you know, their thing. Mm-hmm. I could be wrong. Certainly not every school. I'm just guessing that, you know, at some point or another, parents said, oh, we can't do that. I can't believe you let them play football. It's too dangerous.
It is dangerous.
I'm not claiming it's not dangerous. Yeah. So is letting kids outside generally. Mm. I mean, at some point or another, you're going to have them in a little padded cell and feed them through a tube. So anyway, that's what my thought is. This is not weird. I would say this is normal.
This is, yeah, it's fairly common with zero tolerance policies these days. They just, you know,
childhood has been outlawed now.
Yeah, and a lot of fun has been prohibited. All right, go ahead with the story.
Yep. So a Washington State school district has banned the game of tag.
An entire district?
Yeah.
Okay.
For kids at recess, citing student safety. While at play, especially during recess and unstructured time, students are expected to keep their hands to themselves. The rationale behind this is to ensure the physical and emotional safety of all students. Mercer Island School District Communications Director Mary Grady told local news station Fox Q13 Fox on Wednesday. Parents weren't impressed. What does that statement mean? When a news
that the parents weren't impressed?
Yeah, which parents? All the parents weren't impressed?
The ones they interviewed.
Right. Some parents?
Yeah.
Parents. Two sets of parents were unimpressed. The same couple, they're both parents, were unimpressed.
Uh-huh. Okay. Well, but I mean, it's good news that they were able to find parents who were not happy about this, right?
I guess. I imagine most parents are not happy about it, generally. Like I said, if you go out and ask people generally if schools should be safer, they're all going to say yes. If you go around and ask parents during unstructured play like recess, should your child be able to play tag, they're also going to say yes.
Sure.
Right?
Because like, tag seems like a harmless game to play.
Well, it's all about how the question is put out there. You know, if you ask the question, during recess time, do you think it's okay for little boys to run around and touch little girls wherever they want?
Nope.
Right? They're going to say no to that. But what is tag, ultimately? It's boys running around touching girls or girls running around touching boys or,
usually tag doesn't.
Kids running around touching other kids.
Yeah, but I mean, when you ask the. Right, I see what you're saying. Like, when you ask the question, touching them wherever they want, that implicates the idea that there might be some inappropriate touching going on. Whereas I don't think I've ever seen that happen during a game of tag.
I haven't either. I don't think generally when people are playing tag that that's what they're going to do. Right. However, they are touching them where they want or where they can.
Where you can. That's true.
And this really, for me, this comes back to a certain belief that democracy is a bad idea and people are generally stupid. You shouldn't be asking people these questions. Because you know what the answers are you're going to get.
Well, I don't think they asked them anything. I mean, it's the news that's asking them. The parents weren't consulted in this decision, right? The school board just went ahead and banned tag.
Well, you know, the school board is voted on by individuals and these sorts of things. Yeah. Uh-huh. I mean,
so what?
Nope. The school board probably got sued over some game that was played on, you know, by somebody's parent or something like that, and doesn't want that to happen again.
School
so they're protecting
not liable,
themselves.
Are they? I mean, if kids are playing tag and the, you know, during recess, how could the school board be held liable for that?
If the school is the guardian of the kid at that point, they're liable for everything. Yes, I don't know, you know, what are you going to get? I don't know the answer to that.
Mm-hmm.
But if the lawyer's kid got hurt, the school's liable because he's got time for it.
All
good
right.
Grief. Our kids need some unstructured playtime, Kelsey Joyce told the station. Melissa Nair said, I played tag. I survived. Still another. She's a tag survivor.
Yeah. Good job.
Still another parent noted that now her son, we just can't name this parent. So now her son walks around chatting about video games during recess rather than getting more vigorous exercise.
Mm.
Community members created a Facebook group, Star M1, support tag at recess in Mercer Island.
Well, that'll be the death of their movement.
The decision. What do you mean?
Facebook. I just think Facebook sucks for organizing things. It's just my opinion about it.
If you've got enough people and there's enough momentum, it's a fine place to do that. Plus, this isn't organizational as much as it's sort of PR, too. So people can you know, find out more about it. This story has been picked up and taken further than the local news. So anyway, there's probably a lot of people that are going to support tag at recess at Mercer Island on Facebook and supporting it. And if there's enough people, if the school board goes there and says, oh, my God, there's 12,000 people who've liked this. We better reinstitute tag. They do things like that all the time.
Think so?
They backtrack. Sure. School districts backtrack because they're trying to do what's best for the kids and the families and things like that. And so they'll make decisions like no tag. And then they'll be like, oh, turns out people like tag.
I hope you're right about that.
I don't know. I mean, it could happen. Superintendent Gary Plano brought up the backlash to the new hands-off rule at school board meeting Thursday, according to the Mercer Island Reporter. It's regretful that what seemed to be a well-intentioned desire to help protect kids has taken a life of its own, Plano said, announcing that
he's regretting that people are upset. Right.
He's not the school board. Yeah. I don't know whether he decided to do this or not. Like, he's addressing it. I don't know even know where this guy falls on the position.
All right.
Tag is one of the oldest playground games anywhere. Parent Bill Chilsom said it at the time. To ban tag is just ridiculous. Tag's not the only common childhood activity under attack. Schools nationwide have banned hugging, dodgeball, competitive games in general. Several schools in the United Kingdom have prohibited the concept of best friends. I'd also like to point out, when we go down to Florida, it's right my in-laws live pretty close to a school. And Jack likes to go there during this winter break. The kids are off, and he likes to go there and play on their playground equipment. But their playground equipment isn't like my playground equipment was. There's no, you know, like the merry-go-round.
The slide.
Yeah, the merry-go-round isn't great. There's, you know, I don't think they have a real slide either. They got like the plastic ones that are form-fitted so you can't fall off. Not the metal slide that you can really get going
the
on.
The old school.
And they don't have
polish that sucker up.
The monkey bars. They don't have the monkey bars. They don't have the seesaws.
Seesaws are terrible. I mean, I got to agree with getting rid of seesaws. Nothing. I don't think there's anything that hurts more people more often on a playground than the seesaw.
See, I like to seesaw.
It's designed to hurt people.
It's not designed to hurt people.
It is used by the people who play with it with the purpose of hurting people. You jump off that thing, somebody's going to get hurt.
I think it's a trust issue. You certainly want to get on the seesaw with somebody you trust.
Yeah.
But it also develops quick reflexes, right? So, you know, you gotta have your legs ready up underneath you in case something goes wrong.
Our toll-free number tonight is 855-450-FREE. Your thoughts on playground restrictions. This is Free Talk Live.
Labradors, Goldens are the main breeds that come through our door, but we'll train anything with four legs and a tail. My husband and I train hunting dogs and also have a boarding and grooming business. And our dogs, they're athletes, and we feed them very quality food. You can't get enzymes in a commercial dog food because they cook it at such a high heat. But adding Dynavite to their diet has every single dog in my kennel looking better than they have ever looked.
DINOVITE.com.
859-428-1000.
The omega-3 fatty acids.
Flaxseed, zinc, alfalfa.
The digestive enzymes that are cooked out of regular dog food.
Dynavite's the bomb.
We tell everybody we know about Dynavite.
Just feed your dog right. Use Dynavite. If it's working, don't quit.
When I get down to the bottom of my box of Dynavite, it's time to place my order.
Dynavite.com.
859-428-1000. 859-428-1000.
DINOVITE.com. That's the sound your brain makes when you realize you're buying something and forgot the coupon. Online or in a store, knowing that you're missing a deal is the worst. You need the app from RetailMeNot right now. Get thousands of coupons from 50,000 stores like Kohl's, Domino's, Best Buy, and more with crazy deals like 60% off, free shipping, and free gifts with purchase. You can get a text invite to download the RetailMeNot app 100% free right now for Apple or Android. Just text the code UPDATE to 42767. Then just show your phone at checkout to save. It literally couldn't be easier. It's 2015. Keep your coupons in your phone. Stop what you're doing and text UPDATE to 42767. Listeners will get a text with a link to download it 100% free. Never forget another coupon again. Text the code UPDATE to 42767 right now. That's UPDATE to 42767. Message and data rates may apply. For terms and privacy, visit RetailMeNot.com.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
Want gold but also want to stay digital and decentralized on the Bitcoin blockchain? Anthem Vault, providing trusted, world-class vaulting, has your answer with Hayek Gold. Digital, spendable gold inspired by economist and free market philosopher F.A. Hayek. Each Hayek is worth 1 gram of gold and is available right now at AnthemVault.com. Sign up today at AnthemVault.com with promo code FREEDOM to earn 6 months of free storage and 5% off all margins for life. Hayek Gold at AnthemVault.com. Get yours today.
Do you love Twitter? Make sure you favorite the LRN.FM Twitter account so you can receive our tweets at twitter.lrn.fm. That's twitter.lrn.fm.
Yeah! It's Free Talk Live. You can join us here toll-free, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. With you in studio, it's Ian.
And Mark.
And don't forget, you can join us online. Just drop on by freetalklive.com. Enjoy all the features we have there for you. If you get online and you care about privacy, when you're on the internet, you need ProXPN. It's a virtual private network. They encrypt your online data before it reaches your internet service provider, which means that your ISP will no longer know what you're doing with their internet connection. And that's valuable for a lot of different reasons. Plus, you can get ProXPN for Windows, Mac, iOS, Android, and there's Linux support as well. So there's no reason not to, especially when we can get you a huge discount, 50% off the regular monthly price of the lifetime or for the lifetime of the account. When you buy an annual account with code FTL50, that's code FTL50. Now, that's a pretty darn good deal, but they've topped it. There is now a better deal. For those of you with Bitcoin, you can go to proxpn.com/amp, and when you pay with Bitcoin, you can get 2 years of ProXPN for less than $50 worth of Bitcoin, and $5 out of your purchase price goes to the Free Talk Live AMP program to help spread the ideas of liberty. So everybody wins from this deal. ProXPN.com/AMP. You get a super deep discount on ProXPN, like $50 for 2 years. That's incredible. That's even lower, far lower than the 50% off we talked about before. It's a huge savings, but you only get that savings when you pay with Bitcoin at proxpn.com/amp. You can still use the other code, FTL50, if you don't have Bitcoin, and get a pretty awesome discount that way as well. Help spread the ideas of liberty and take back your privacy. proxpn.com/amp or code FTL50 as we continue here. Mark, you were telling us about a school district in Washington State that has banned tag. It is no longer allowed for the attendees of any school in this district to play the classic children's game, which has been enjoyed for generations upon generations. I don't know who invented tag, but I imagine it was a long time ago when that happened.
Yeah, I'm betting that's a pretty old game,
yeah.
Would be my guess. I can't imagine, but in some version or another, that seems like it's been around probably longer than, say, farming.
I remember I did get hurt playing tag one time, and that really didn't have anything to do with the fact that tag was being played as much as I ran and jumped off of the top level of one of those large kind of playground structures when I was in fifth grade, and they have like a, kind of a quarter circle of bars that went from one from the top to the other. My foot caught in the bar. I kind of swung down. And then I hit my head on one of the wooden portions of the structure. And
this explains so much.
And yeah, it was very bloody, actually.
I
bet
it was.
When you get a head wound, it's bloody. It wasn't a real deep wound or anything like that, but it was kind of a shocking moment for me. But again, it didn't really have much to do with the fact that I was playing tag. I think that could have happened anyway. You know, because kids are generally going to run around doing something at recess, unless they ban running entirely. Which maybe they'll do, but I don't think they've done that yet.
Yeah.
It's probably coming next.
So, the form tag, touching is integral to tag.
That's right.
I just can't see how you would play tag without touching, but the rules
There's laser
here,
tag.
There is laser tag, but...
Which is awesome.
Indeed. Not as cool as paintball, but takes less prep.
Yeah, there are fewer equipment that you need. There are fewer things that you need to do laser tag than paintball. And laser tag doesn't hurt as much. You know, if you've ever been shot by a paintball in certain sensitive areas, like your throat, that can be an uncomfortable time.
I don't think I've gotten shot in the throat.
Me neither, thank goodness. But I've known people who have.
I did play paintball a couple of times, at least one time with you. And
my God, when was that?
It was more than 10 years ago.
I don't remember that.
We got pwned by a group of kids.
Oh, yeah?
Just got ate up by some like preteen boys.
Was it indoor or outdoor?
It was indoor there off Televast or whatever
I'll
it is.
Be damned.
Myrtle, I think. It was some time ago.
Okay.
And it was a good time. But laser tag, if you go to a place that has sort of the gear, the chest set up, then it makes more sense. But the laser tags I've played, often it's set up in the gun, right? Like, so you're just trying to shoot each other's guns.
Yeah.
And that's not as, it doesn't feel as realistic, you know? Like, you want to be able to aim that thing right at the head of the other guy and get
Well, they're certainly not going to let anybody with a laser tag gun on a school campus. Yeah. and paintball is out of the question. So, yeah, so much for tag. And I wonder if this is going to spread. Now, you're suggesting, Mark, that it's going to turn around, that maybe the parents are going to pressure the school board into flipping the policy back and allowing tag again. But what was it? They formed a Facebook group. I think the part of the story you were at was the sort of the pushback from the parents. One of the bureaucrats was acknowledging that it exists.
Yeah, there was a Facebook group that was created. It was it's called... I'm sorry, Mercer Island. Star MI. Support tag at recess in Mercer Island. So it's a Facebook group. Star MI is the idea. And I think that, yes, at some point or another, the pendulum always swings. At some point, it swings back. Now, it usually doesn't swing as far, but and that's kind of how progress goes. So they were pointing out in the article here from Huffington Post that some schools have banned hugging. Because, come on, we know what hugging's all about, right? It's boys wanting to touch girls in spots that they're uncomfortable being touched. Come on, be serious.
I don't know anything about that.
Hugging it's just one step from human trafficking. I mean, there's crazy people out there that say things like this, that this is what it is. It's prurient. Young people rubbing up against each other.
No. We've talked about one of those stories before, Mark, and that's not the reason given by the bureaucrats for banning it. The reason for banning hugging is that it makes people jealous, right? That's the reason why public displays of affection of all sorts are purportedly prohibited on school campuses, and that is because the people who aren't in a relationship will feel bad if they see somebody having a hug or a kiss or holding hands with another person.
Wants to touch her and nobody wants to touch me? Mm-hmm. Why does he get to touch everybody and I never get to touch anybody? Yeah, I see. Okay, fine. That's another reason. I don't know if that's the only reason.
I don't think it's okay. I mean, I support public displays of affection, but, you know, that's the reason they've given.
You know, when it comes to hugging, maybe I'm the only guy on the planet that thinks this way, Ian, but I'm going to go ahead.
That is an excuse to cop a feel?
That I'm going to go ahead and say that there are some people I like to hug more than other people.
Yeah.
Like, I feel differently about hugging
if
different types of people.
If you're not pinching their butt, then it's not copping a feel.
I'm not claiming it's copping a feel, Ian. I'm telling you how I feel when I do it.
You feel lecherous?
Sometimes I'm, you know, hugging
That's
certain
weird,
people.
Dude.
I'm like,
where does that come
this
from?
This is nice. I'd like to do this more.
Where does that come from? Is it because where does that originate?
I'm gonna say a lizard brain that causes people to have sex.
Are you saying it arouses you when you hug someone?
Well, I'm not physically, if that's what you're saying. I haven't had enough time generally. The hug comes, it goes. But, you know, yeah. This doesn't happen for you?
No, not at all. No.
Yeah, I don't think you're motivated like normal guys are either.
No,
frankly.
I guess not. I mean, hugging has always seemed to be just a friendly thing to do, not a sexual thing in any way, shape, or form. It's just me. 855-450-FREE. Is hugging a turn-on? You can share your thoughts here. 855-450-3733. Or is it something that people do today? I gave James Cleveland a hug today.
I don't think there's anything wrong. I've hugged you plenty of times. I try to hug people because I think humans touching each other is a good thing.
That's what the hugging seems to be about to me, is just humans contacting other humans because we're a very social creature. But you can share your thoughts here and join us at Free Talk Live at 855-450-FREE.
No way. Is that a real bullet necklace?
No, it's a 9mm bullet necklace with matching earrings, you'll notice.
Those are awesome. Where'd you get them?
Dave found them at PatriotNecklace.com.
Wow.
They have a variety of calibers and necklaces and earrings and keychains.
PatriotNecklace.com?
PatriotNecklace.com.
Your choice of caliber bullet includes a rugged American-made stainless steel dog tag chain. A percentage of every sale goes to military and service-related charities. And get a discount by entering GCN at checkout. Show your patriotism and support our troops with a bullet necklace from PatriotNecklace.com.
Hunters, anglers, campers, and survivalists, get back to nature. Expand your horizons with the highest quality, most versatile, unique slingshots and slingbows on the market at slingbow.com. Slingbow products are compact and models start from just $17.98. They're perfect for your bug-out bag or storing in your vehicle. Give yourself and your loved ones the excitement and tradition of slingbow, a new frontier in archery and truly modern twist on this primitive survival tool. Feel the thrill only at slingbow.com.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project, and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
There comes a time when you need custom embroidered or screen printed apparel for your business, organization, or a special event. Corporate Casuals has been helping people create great looking logoed apparel for over 25 years. They can produce a single piece or thousands using name brand apparel like Nike, Patagonia, Adidas, and Hanes. Create your logo in their online embroidery design studio or upload your existing logo and they'll turn it into embroidery. Go to corporatecasuals.com/FTL and include FTL in the order notes and save 5% on your order.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to saveitpurse.com and open an account. Do this right now. Don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to saveitpurse.com right now, get signed up, and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 15 to 25% off of everything at Amazon through saveitpurse.com. It's saveatpurse.com.
Listen to LRN.FM on any phone, anytime. 213-493-0309. That's 213-493-0309.
It's Free Talk Live. Of course, you can join us right here toll-free at 855-450-FREE. And maybe you're someone who supports the banning of the classic child's game, Tag. It has happened in one Washington State school district, and it could be coming to a school district near you. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Also, Skype in. It's Skype username lrn.fm. With you tonight here, you've got me, Ian.
And me, Mark.
And Mark, tell me something that's super important and interesting.
Well, I want to tell you about James versus the New World Order. This is a graphic novel that's coming out, and it's intriguing. So here's the copy here. What would you do when a bizarre occult army calling itself the Trust invades your sleepy little mountain hometown? Find out what James Cantrell, a big-hearted country boy with a crappy job who's learned to live without dreams, what he does. Because sometimes the guy who's learned to live without dreams might be the best suited to handle a nightmare. Read the action comedy graphic novel James vs. the New World Order by Brandon Bitros and illustrated by J. Matthew Root, the first in what is estimated to be a 5-volume, 24-issue series. So, if this intrigues you, go to JamesVS.TheNewWorldOrder.com to contribute to the Kickstarter crowdfunding campaign to raise $3,000 to pay for the artwork, coloring, production, and distribution. It's JamesVS.TheNewWorldOrder.com. And really what this isn't contributions as much as this is a pre-order. This is going to take place. You're going to get what you pay for. And it's a great thing. It's just a way to get the sort of the money set up ahead of time. And
So go and get and do your pre-order at jamesvsthenewworldorder.com.
Let's talk to Michael. He's in Massachusetts listening to LRN.FM. Hey, Michael.
Hello there.
Welcome. You're on the air.
So this past weekend, driving my car in the middle of the day, and could be any town in America, but it happens to be in Brockton, Massachusetts. When I look in my rearview mirror, and I see the all-too-familiar blue lights, and I get that feeling in the stomach like I'm pretty much sure everyone does.
Mm-hmm.
So I was driving to the bakery to pick up a cake for my mother for her birthday, and I was right in front of the bakery, so I pull into the bakery, essentially, to get off the road, make it a little safer. I happen to be a liberty activist, so I broke out my cell 411 app, and I alerted some friends. Unfortunately, I don't have anyone in my local area on that network.
That's because you're in Massachusetts.
Right. Touché. Had I been in the Shire. But I started live streaming, and I informed the officer right away when he came up to the window that I was recording. And
how
so,
do you take that?
State police or local?
It was a local cop.
Okay.
So if he asked me, you know, you know why I pulled you over, it was because of an old inspection sticker that was past due.
You know, inspection stickers, I see them up here in the Northeast, and I don't know exactly what to think about them. They got rid of them in Florida when I was a kid. I remember the inspection sticker from back, you know, maybe like 79 or something, but the legislature got rid of them. And Florida roads aren't exactly littered with abandoned vehicles out there. People are getting where they need to go, and you know, things are happening. People are liable for the responsibilities of you know, something goes wrong with their vehicle, but that's their problem, not an inspection. Why do you think they've got them up here?
Simply another means of control by the state, so that you have to pay them some coin, and if you don't, if you disobey, they're going to, you know, fine you to put you in place, X, Y, and Z.
All right, so you sent out a notice, you got pulled over, you started recording the cop, and then what?
Yeah. It was pretty uneventful. I stayed in the car, he went back to his car, but when he came back to my window, he just gave me the ticket and pretty much took off. I asked for his badge number, his name. There's badge number 387, Patrolman Perez. And what he added to the ticket, aside from the inspection sticker, was a seatbelt violation and failure to pull over for emergency vehicle, which brought the total to about $200.
Woo! Failure to pull over?
Yeah, what does that mean, failure to pull over? Did you not pull over? How did he give you a ticket if you didn't pull over?
You know, right when I saw him in the rear view, I was coming up to the bakery. So instead of staying on the road right in front of the bakery, I decided to pull in and make it a little safer.
Yeah, I really, this is another thing. And I wish that some law enforcement officer would call in and tell me what this is about. But police officers pulling people over right on the road, especially like roads with curbs, doesn't make much sense to me. The idea behind giving out a ticket is to make the road a safer place for everyone, so that traffic gets through, gets to where it's going in a most expeditious fashion. You've got to have a pretty good reason to stop the flow of traffic in a lane, you know, as far as I'm concerned, and this is what they're doing. It's unsafe for them. It's unsafe for you. More so for them, because they're more likely to get rear-ended out there. And, you know, somebody who gets a big old dent in the hood of their car because some cop is, you know, parked out in the middle of the road.
They get upset, Mark, because you're not doing what they want you to do right away. I remember I got a cop pulled me over the one time I was pulled over.
I'm trying to help them. I want to get them out of the road.
I understand that, but they're not thinking about that. They're thinking this person is disobeying. This person is not doing what I put my lights on. They are supposed to pull over immediately.
I had a lady, a female cop down in Florida, said I pulled over too quickly.
Oh, really?
It scared her. So who knows what this is? I mean, yep. I saw her. I saw her turn around. I figured what was up. She turns on her lights. I get over. She's like, why'd you pull over so quickly? Well, because I don't know.
Yeah, you're right. You just can't satisfy these people. All right, so what now, Michael? What's next for you?
I guess I'm calling essentially looking for advice. I was kind of thinking of some ideas. I don't know if perhaps like Freedom of Information Act requests for any misconduct alleged by some individuals against him to his department.
What would the purpose of that be? To bring it up in court to make him look unreliable? Yeah, you know, that's an interesting approach. I've never heard of that one before. It might be worth a try. So it sounds like you're willing to go to court.
Yeah, I want to take the ticket to court. And it's just the one, it's him being dishonest. I don't know whether it's because I was filming him or I do have a lot of Liberty stickers in the back of my car. So that might have made him upset or... X, Y, or Z. It's completely arbitrary why he added those two things.
So, yeah, I mean, we don't give advice here on Free Talk Live. That's a legal sort of term, but I'm happy to give suggestions based on my experience. And my experience says that, yeah, you absolutely should take this to court. It's an interesting approach to ask to get the police officer's record. I don't know, you know, I don't know what effect it'll have. I don't know how long it'll take them to spit that out at you. I know that in New Hampshire they've got like 30 days, so they'll probably get it to you before you actually end up having to go to trial. I've been in enough Massachusetts courtrooms to know generally what sort of goes on there during arraignments. A lot of times, you know, you'll go in there and they'll cut a deal with you to just give them $50 and make it go away. That happens day in, day out.
Yeah, that happened to me when I was in Mass.
In these Massachusetts courtrooms. So
you
probably
don't even see a judge at first. They call themselves magistrates.
Yep.
Magistrates, yep.
So, I mean...
Yeah, so it's a civil... It's not criminal. It's a civil thing. It's going to go before magistrates. So I don't even know if there's even going to be proceedings. This is my first time taking a ticket to court.
Oh, good. It'll be an educational experience for you. See if you can bring some friends of yours with you. It can. You can actually record video in Massachusetts courts, but they make you jump through some extra hoops. So if you want to record it, you'll have to show up like at least an hour early just so you can jump through whatever hoops they put up for you, filling out the various different paperwork or whatever. And, of course, the other thing is the long-term plan of moving to New Hampshire, where you're more likely to have people respond, although right now we're still working on spreading cell 411. There's not enough coverage of cell 411, but we have other systems here that we can use to alert one another to things that are going on. And thank you and good luck, Michael, for the call tonight. I appreciate it. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. And that advice, and it's not advice, those suggestions, those apply to anybody who wants to try to clog the system, get a little legal experience. If you've got a ticket or something like that that's not a real serious penalty, never hurts to take it to court. Well, I guess... In my experience, it never hurts. There might be some states where they charge you ridiculous court costs, in which case it would hurt you to take it to court. It's Free Talk Live. As a pioneer of the e-commerce movement, Overstock.com is proud to be the first major retailer to accept Bitcoin. Overstock was the first because Patrick Byrne, Overstock CEO and founder, firmly believes in personal freedom and cryptocurrency. Over the past 16 years, Overstock has furnished over 18 million homes with a diverse line of products to suit everyone's unique styles and preferences. Support Overstock and freedom of choice while enjoying free shipping on orders of 0.211 Bitcoin or more.
Get your Plenty card at Exxon or Mobil and start earning points at lots of places.
So I get points for filling up at Exxon?
You sure do.
What about getting coffee at Mobil?
Points.
Streaming TV shows on Hulu?
Definitely.
Points on my AT&T wireless bill?
Yep.
Buying soap?
At Rite Aid.
Buying you a birthday present?
Points at Macy's.
Visiting your parents?
No. You get marriage points.
Oh.
Exxon and Mobil are the only fuel brands that are part of Plenty, the rewards program that lets you earn points at one place and use them at another. Join Plenty for free through a participating Exxon or Mobil station today. Terms and limitations apply. See Plenty.com/partners for details.
No way. Is that a real bullet necklace?
No, it's a 9mm bullet necklace with matching earrings, you'll notice.
Those are awesome. Where'd you get them?
Dave found them at PatriotNecklace.com.
Wow.
They have a variety of calibers and necklaces and earrings and keychains.
PatriotNecklace.com?
PatriotNecklace.com.
Your choice of caliber bullet includes a rugged American-made stainless steel dog tag chain. A percentage of every sale goes to military and service-related charities. And get a discount by entering GCN at checkout. Show your patriotism and support our troops with a bullet necklace from PatriotNecklace.com.
Okay, open your mouth and say ah.
Ah.
When your child has a sore throat, you need to know when to get help. The doctor-recommended Say-Ah Sore Throat Exam is your solution. The scientifically designed oral retractor offers a clear view of the throat, relaxing the tongue, and minimizing gag reflex. Compare with a medical-grade chart, website, and app. Then you'll know just what to tell your doctor. A wellness plan in your hands in minutes. Go to sayahnow.com. Sayahnow.com, the new mainstay for every family's first aid kit.
Money, power, and respect are all yours at CreditSuccessSecretsRevealed.com. Be seen as an industry leader. You can do it. The last application you filled out when it was time to hit submit, did your nerves spike? You didn't get the approval you seek, but there's a better way. We teach you exactly what to place into the right systems the right way the first time so you get approved. Get up to $100,000 in instant business credit. Many people will get cash on the spot. Use those two tools in your new corporate credit engine so you can walk into the bank and get your project funded today. It's all about today at CreditSuccessSecretsRevealed.com. Credit Success Secrets Revealed is explosive and ignites instant results. Dial 1-800-707-8719. That's 1-800-707-8719. 1-800-707-8719. Or just go to CreditSuccessSecretsRevealed.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
BlakeDevelopment.net is a global leader in website creation, app development, and online marketing, catering to businesses of all sizes. There's really no job too big or too small for BlakeDevelopment.net. Do you have an idea for a killer app, but you don't know how to code it? Are you missing out on online sales? Or maybe your business needs help with social media? Websites start at just $200, and they're offering 3 years of free domain registry. Yes, they take Bitcoin. 844-SITE-123. BlakeDevelopment.net, 844-SITE-123.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. You're invited to join us here. Toll free, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Maybe you think tags should be banned. Apparently there are some people who believe in that concept, that there should be a prohibition on playing tag at government schools. That is what has happened in one Washington State school district where they have prohibited tag. It's causing some uproar, but will it be enough of an uproar to reverse the school district's policy? And of course, we aren't always the best at getting the follow-up stories, so if you hear the news before we do, feel free to let us know. Or better yet, post it right there to the front page of our website at freetalklive.com. That is probably one of the best ways for us to see what you think is interesting, and you know, we might just talk about it on the air. So whatever it is that you want to share with our listeners and the hosts of the show, you just post it right there at freetalklive.com. It's a Reddit-based system, so it's free to use. And right now, the headline, the top article over at freetalklive.com, as submitted by you, was submitted by TVcom. FTL, a crazy love triangle, is the article. And
it's good stuff.
It's actually a self-written piece. So over at freetalklive.com, you can do you can post in one of two ways. The most popular way to post is to post a link to some other thing on the internet. So blog post, YouTube video, news article, whatever. The other way is you can write up your own original content on our site and post that. And that's what that person has done. So the number one voted item at the moment was actually written by the person who posted it and posted to our site. Number two, NASA, strong evidence of flowing water on the Martian surface. This has been pretty big news in a lot of ways.
It's a big deal. They're calling it flowing water. I'm going to call it flowing water, too. They say it's salt water, but where there's water, there tends to be life.
Yeah.
Now, what I thought was the best about this is I happened to catch Rush Limbaugh today. I don't spend a lot of time listening to Rush, but I did catch him today. I was, out. I had to go visit. I visit a friend every Monday at the nursing home.
That's nice.
I take him, have a little chat, and then we go to the grocery store, and he's got to get the, treats. Essentially, they take care of everything he needs, but he likes treats. I'm not entirely sure what those treats are. His bag is opaque.
Gotcha.
I'd kind of like to know. None of my business. But nonetheless, heard Rush today, and he opened up his show literally talking about a conspiracy theory about Mars having water not being true, because everything the liberal media puts out is some kind. There's a message. There's a reason for it. And
this is a liberal plot.
It's a liberal plot. The liberal plot is to suggest this was it. I'm not kidding. It didn't stop here. Uh-huh. That just to say, you know what? I don't care about these pointless things that don't change my life. Because there's an argument for that. My life isn't going to be changed tomorrow as a result of having found out today that this, you know, what I consider to be sort of exciting and buoying news that there's water found on Mars. Mm-hmm. My life will not change markedly. However, he said that what his speculation was, this is the guy that's right 99.whatever% of the time, according to his own commercials, okay, from some kind of organization that rates him. You've heard
is
that, right?
Is it the EIB network that rates him?
No, it's some you know, rating agency or something.
Okay.
And he speculated that the liberals would lie about the water, then lie about a civilization that had crumbled on Mars, you know, millennia ago. And the reason they had was because they had damaged their own atmosphere to the point that they were destroyed.
Wow. So
I know, man. Here you go, Fonzie. Jump this shark.
Oh, man. So wait. So no one had actually made that claim.
No.
He's speculating.
He knows these people like every inch of his glorious naked body. He can defeat them with half of his brain tied behind his back. This is what he was saying. Now,
yes,
maybe,
but can he defeat the Martians with half his brain tied
maybe
behind his back?
He has defeated us. Maybe we're the liberals, and maybe he's defeated us by simply having us talk about this cockamamie bullcrap he was on the air talking about.
Unbelievable.
I'm ready to turn both barrels on Rush Limbaugh on this one. I mean, really? I mean, just at this point, because we don't spend a lot of time talking about other hosts on Free Talk Live, but
no.
Rush, has Rush gone insane?
I don't know, but there's a question.
I mean, the last time I listened to his show, it was full of conspiracy theory, but most of the conspiracy theories sort of aimed at the Democrats and the liberal media, the Clinton war machine, whatever it is Obama and crew are doing. There's always a conspiracy afoot. He knows these people like every inch of his glorious naked body.
I'm always intrigued and entertained by the sort of the mainstream political party conspiracies. They do exist. You know, whenever we talk about conspiracy theories here on Free Talk Live, we're generally referring to the 9/11 truthers, the chemtrails, you know, these people that have the courtroom conspiracy theorists. We've got a variety of conspiracy types that will call the show and pitch their current theory or the same old theory that they've been pitching for a decade that they're hoping everybody's going to get on board with, and then some sort of miracle is going to happen to change the government. Those are entertaining on their own and sometimes annoying, but that's what's most common, at least, that we come across. But every now and then you'll hear about the Democrats have a conspiracy theory or the Republicans have a conspiracy theory. You just gave a Republican conspiracy theory a moment ago. One of the Democrat ones is that the Free State Project is funded by the Koch brothers, who are like these billionaire brothers who do put a lot of money into certain aspects, more like the think tanky aspects of the liberty movement, like Cato Institute, for instance, I think gets some money from the Koch brothers, if I'm not mistaken. But the Free State Project doesn't. But yet there's all kinds of conspiracy theories surrounding the Free State Project, as though it's only the Koch brothers that could make this happen. And furthermore, there's also like generic Free State Project conspiracies. So the Free State Project is the idea of liberty-oriented people moving to New Hampshire and getting active. I remember a long time ago there was a rumor going around Keene that there was a Secret Seven. Some sort of secret group of Free Staters who meets and decides who knows what. But like, there was actually this rumor going around. And so that doesn't have any sort of political bias.
You don't know
to
about
it.
The Secret Seven? I guess you're not part of the Secret Seven.
No, I'm definitely not.
Well, I knew that.
But no, there's no Secret Seven, and that's ridiculous.
Really? What makes you think so? Because you don't have that information?
Go on, Mark.
So, I mean, this is what it's all about. I think that when it comes to the conspiracy theories, people are always trying to sort of ferret out what the reason for something is. People have said many times that Free Talk Live wouldn't be on the air if it wasn't for some powerful donors making sure that we were here. Nothing could be further from the truth, and somebody who says that is divorced from reality.
Well, we've had some really great cornerstone sponsors over the years.
Were on the air before they came around?
MemoryDealers.com, yep. Sakel CAI.
Yep, those are two big ones.
Really great sponsors we had.
But they're not on the board right now,
They're not on board right now.
Were they on board when we started?
No, not when we started.
Okay, so not when we started and not now.
Right.
So, no, that is not an accurate statement.
Okay, no, it's not.
And it's not an accurate statement. No, we've certainly had some sponsors and some people who are ideologically motivated who sponsor the show. And please, if that is you, get a hold of me tomorrow. It's Mark at freetalklive.com, and I'll sell you some ad packages.
Sure.
But nonetheless, Free Talk Live is not on the air because of some powerful, wealthy people.
No, it's mostly because of the hundreds of supporters that we have.
No, it's the radio stations that choose to air Free Talk Live.
I include them in our hundreds of supporters.
The amplifier certainly managed to make that happen, but if the product stunk, it wouldn't be on the air.
That's true. Yeah, we don't pay stations for airtime. No, if we suck.
That's the suggestion behind these conspiracy theorists is that not only are they paying our paycheck, which is minimal at that, but they're paying these radio stations to put us on because we're that awful.
Oh, man.
Right? So those people are divorced from reality, as I had said. And that's what what somebody's saying should matter in some way, shape, or form of how they're being funded.
Now, where do you hear this theory?
I've heard it said before.
Is it a local theory or is it online?
No, I've heard it on Facebook. Okay. And people saying things. People,
interesting.
Nasty people that don't have a rebuttal to the thing that you're saying.
Of course.
Will then attempt to make essentially an ad hominem attack at that point. There's no Latin for a radio show, but that's what they're doing. And they when somebody makes a point, the best thing to do is to rebut the point. Certainly, we've said things on Free Talk Live that are wrong or inefficient or the best way to go about things or whatever. But to suggest that we're being funded by some deep dark group of cabal of libertarians that wants to take over the world. I mean, if you know where these people are, for God's sake, give them my number. Have them call me. That's not the case.
No, it doesn't work that way. So you can join us here on the radio waves, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And we have Skype. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. Coming up, our former co-host Derrick J. Freeman has been denied his supposed right to concealed carry a firearm. And this is by the Supreme Court. We'll tell you about that here in moments. 855-450-FREE is our number. You can join us here and bring up anything that's on your mind. It's Free Talk Live.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom. And with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
If you expect secure, privacy-oriented services and real human support from your web hosting provider, choose Virtual Space International. From domain names and SSL certificates to offshore banking accounts, Virtual Space International has been the all-in-one, multi-language solution for over 25 years. And satisfaction is guaranteed or your money back. We even accept Bitcoin. Find out how to get 50% off for life at SaveTimeHosting.com.
This is your Robertson Roberts Brokerage Daily Precious Metals Update. In early trading Monday, gold is $15 lower at $1,132 per ounce. Silver is down 50 cents at $14.66 per ounce. Bitcoin is trading at $237. This is a great time to buy on the dips. We have plenty of silver spiders, Britannias, and kangaroos in stock. Give us a call at 800-874-9760 or visit us online at rrbi.co.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Monday, September 28th, 2015. Silver is trading at $14.70 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,132 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $238. Antiwar.com reports early reports of the Islamic State trying to establish an affiliate in Afghanistan were mostly downplayed by the U.S. and other Western powers, who believed the group to be little more than a handful of disaffiliated Taliban commanders trying to get international attention. That the rare the Islamic State activity was all fighting against the Taliban rivals seemed to support that. Sunday, the Islamic State gunmen attacked a police checkpoint in Nangarhar, killing 3 and wounding 8 in the first real attack against the Afghan security force. The attack comes amid reports of a growing the Islamic State influence across the nation and a huge recruitment effort spanning 25 provinces. Indeed, the latest report suggests that only about 10% of the Islamic State force inside Afghanistan is Taliban defectors, and that the group's parent organization in Iraq and Syria has sent roughly 70 seasoned commanders to serve as the leadership core of this growing branch. The ability to recruit Taliban defectors might be growing with the latest leadership disputes in that group, but the ability of the Islamic State to form an almost entirely new group with so little crossover with a Taliban insurgency that's been in place for decades suggests they are resonating with a whole new group of people and could be a hugely complicating matter in the ongoing occupation of Afghanistan.
For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
UPI reports President Obama and Raul Castro will meet Tuesday at the United Nations to discuss the developing relationship between the United States and Cuba. In Cuba's first UN General Assembly since the two countries renewed diplomatic relations, the White House said Obama will hold a bilateral meeting with Castro. This is the second face-to-face between Obama and Castro since diplomatic relations were restored in late 2014. They also met in April at the Summit of the Americas meeting in Panama and have spoken by phone. Ben Rhodes, Obama's Deputy National Security Advisor for Strategic Communications, called Castro's UN visit very significant and a symbol we're in a new era of U.S.-Cuba relations. On Friday, he met with several members of Congress who support the renewed relations. While at the United Nations, Obama will meet with the President of Kazakhstan, Prime Minister of India, and possibly Vladimir Putin to discuss topics that include concerns about a Russian military buildup in Syria.
Are you an advocate for free market money? Do you promote Bitcoin as an alternative in a fiat-centric world? Then you need Spendabit in your arsenal, the search engine for things you can buy with Bitcoin. Spendabit aggregates millions of products from thousands of Bitcoin-enabled merchants. Keep your money in the free economy. Visit spendabit.co today. Bitcoin merchants, ask about our merchant suite to reach even more customers. Spendabit.co.
Reuters reports separatists on Sunday won a clear majority of seats in Catalonia's parliament in an election that sets the region on a collision course with Spain's central government over independence. With secessionist parties securing 72 out of 135 seats in the region of 7.5 million people that includes Barcelona, acting regional government head Artur Mas told reporters Catalans have voted yes to independence. The strong pro-independence showing dealt a blow to Spanish Prime Minister Mariano Rajoy
3 months before a national election. His center-right government, which has opposed attempts to hold a referendum on secession, has called the separatist plan a nonsense and vowed to block it in court. The main secessionist group, Together for Yes, won 62 seats, while the smaller leftist CUP party earned 10 seats. Both had said before the vote that such a result would allow them to unilaterally declare independence within 18 months under a plan that would see the new Catalan authorities approving their own constitution and building institutions like an army, central bank, and judicial system. Mas said a democratic mandate now exists to move forward with independence. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
College roommates continue their bonding process until real friends are made, and a teacher hopes they never Google him. It's time for the weekly video feature that's heartier and more comforting than a heaping bowl of mom's butternut squash soup. This is the Onion Week in Review. Longtime James F. Blaine Elementary School teacher Suzanne Pomponio told reporters today that she could not believe how much fatter her second graders are getting. Pomponio estimates that each and every one of her kids must be 8 to 10 pounds heavier than anyone in her 2011 class, adding, quote, "and those kids were pretty fat too."
Honestly, I didn't think it was possible that this year's kids could be fatter than last year's, but they are. I mean, short kids are fat, tall kids are fat, and there's a smell. I don't really know how to describe it.
Local dad Michael Corain navigated several discount travel websites today with a precision reminiscent of 18th century Viennese prodigy Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart composing a symphony.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live.
It's Free Talk Live, and you can join us here. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Coming up, our former Monday night co-host, who is now living it up in San Francisco, Derrick J. Freeman, has received a New Hampshire Supreme Court decision on his right to carry concealed case.
Right in quotation marks.
Yeah, you think you have a right? Just wait till you ask permission for it. We'll tell you what happened in a few moments. Also, you can join us here at 855-450-FREE. Bring up whatever's on your mind. We've got Skype. Skype on in here at username lrn.fm. It's Ian and Mark in the studio, and we'll start out with Mike in Tennessee on the line. Mike, you're on Free Talk Live. Go ahead.
Greetings, gentlemen. If I can explain the reason that you're on so many affiliates. Now, let me ask you, are your affiliates listed on your website?
Well, yes, they are. As a matter of fact, you can go to affiliates.freetalklive.com and see the full list of over 150 radio stations.
Well, I appreciate it, because that way, when we're traveling, if we want to listen to the show instead of tuning in Genesis, we can go straight to the affiliates and find out and listen to those stations. So that's a good thing.
Sure.
What you have is what I would refer to as the filler effect. In dog food, they put so much meat, and then normally the number one ingredient is corn, which is a filler, because they've got to fill in all these voids. And because you're already spearing the state propaganda line of conspiracy theory, they're going to love you. And actually, they should be paying you. I mean, seriously.
They should.
You could get... Yes, sir. They should be paying you big time because you're supporting the government's propaganda of...
What are you talking about?
Which conspiracy theory, though? We were talking about liberal conspiracy theories, conservative conspiracy theories.
No. Government. Government. Anytime the government does something and they put out a propaganda story, unless the government says so, you agree with the government. That's why you call 9/11.
I don't think you've ever listened to the show before. I mean, generally, if the government says something, we're super skeptical of it.
No, sir. The first 2 minutes I ever talked to you, you called me conspiracy theorist when I told you that the people in Virginia that were killed were not really killed. They were actors, that girl and the cameraman.
Oh, yeah, you're that guy.
He's not that guy. There's people, hundreds of people all over the internet that have these.
He's the guy who's called the show about that particular issue. You're talking about the Lester or Vester Flanagan shooting.
Yeah, but so your theory is kind of has some holes in it. There's a lot of people out there that do a lot of shows. It's not just Free Talk Live that will go ahead and say that, you know, that was the truth and that toe the government's line in whatever way it is that you claim that we do. I mean, considering that we undermine the government at every opportunity, you'd think that they'd have a more statist program to plug in, wouldn't you?
Well, let me prove to you.
It's all part of the plot.
Do you believe that Building 7 fell in free fall because of a fire?
Do you think that the government cares about my opinion on that?
My point exactly. You won't answer the question.
I don't know.
See, Mark,
frankly,
that's proof that you're a disinformation agent.
I really don't know what happened with Building 7. Okay, I find that to be the most interesting part of the whole 9/11 conspiracy theory thing is the Building Number 7. But the fact that Alex Jones is on radio stations, not as many as Free Talk Live, but on a lot of them, and he fully draws that into question, sort of undermines your point that we're on because we toe the government's line. I mean, this seems this is the most ridiculous claim that I've heard of reasons why Free Talk Live is on radio stations.
He's probably the number one internet radio show, and you can go to Talkstream Live when he's on, and he's up there number one, number
yeah,
two.
Yeah, absolutely. Alex Jones pwns us on the internet, but on radio stations, we're on a few more.
But, Mark, he ignored your point, and
right,
that is that
he
Alex
doesn't care about a point. He's a conspiracy theorist. They don't have points.
Well, but no, your point was that Alex Jones is on radio stations, so how can that happen, Mike?
I deal with facts and truth. My point being
the fact of the truth is that Alex Jones is on dozens of radio stations. Why has the government allowed him to be on there?
It's commercial. They can't stop it.
They can't stop us from being on.
No, they want you on because you're
mind-numbed.
Thanks,
blather.
Mike, for the call tonight. I've heard enough. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. I was hoping he was going to go into the Alex Jones conspiracy theory. See, there's a conspiracy theory that Alex Jones actually is a CIA agent. And that the Genesis Communications Network is just a front for the government.
You never hear about the CIA anymore. It's always the NSA, right? Like, it used to be the CIA was everything, but the NSA is a large organization. Now it's always about them. I wonder what the CIA is doing these days. No, Alex Jones is a very nice guy.
Yeah,
we've met him, and he's a great dude. He's on the radio stations he's on, in part because he produces a really great radio program. He rules on the internet. There's no doubt about it. He's got a lot of people that listen that way. I'd say he's more of a niche program in the sense that, a lot of people just the conspiracy theory thing doesn't resonate with them. I'm certain that there are conspiracies out there. We can point to them. Historically, you can go and you can find these things. Turns out this is true. Turns out that's true. There's a whole variety of them. But when you sit out there and just point out everything being conspiracy theory, I'm not claiming Alex Jones does that, but I will claim that there are some people that just don't believe bad things happen anymore. Like, someone got shot.
It must have been the government.
Right. Somebody got shot. It must be a plot to trick us into not paying attention to this other news story. Mm-hmm. Well, no, I can't. I just can't get on board with that. I don't know what happened to Building 7. I don't know what happened to Building 7.
That's not good enough for the conspiracy theorist, Mark. If you aren't on board 100%, right? If you're not on board 100% with their idea, and a lot of them have different ideas about how all that stuff went down on 9/11, but if you're not on board with the conspiracy theory 100%, then you must be working for the government. And it's ridiculous.
He didn't claim
that.
He claimed we were patsies as opposed to shills.
Well, didn't he say we were getting paid?
We should be getting paid, is what he said.
Oh, okay.
He didn't make that
claim. So we're patsies for the government. Whatever. We're doing the government's bidding, whether they are instructing us to or not.
Which is just
the suggestion.
Ridiculous.
Yeah.
Every time Ian gets an opportunity to suggest that a police officer or a politician has done some horrifying thing, he will do that.
Almost. I mean, I could fill the show up with bad cop stories, and then we'd be Cop Block Radio, which is a great show in its own volition, and I don't want to try to duplicate what they're doing. There's a lot more worth talking about in the world besides terrible police abuse stories, although we do cover them often enough. And, yeah, I mean, we're constantly against the state on Free Talk Live. We have a philosophical disagreement with the idea of the state on this program, and we put it out there, the idea of coercive government. We put it out there that we're against those concepts almost 7 nights a week. I mean, if a night goes by where we're not crystal clear on that, then it's just a chance happening that we weren't crystal clear that
night.
What's
that dude's, what was the caller's name?
Mike in Tennessee.
Mike, call another radio show with your lunatic theory about shooting some the this whatever it is about shooting the TV anchors. Call them. and see if you get on the air. And then tell me what a conspiracy theory Free Talk Live is, because we'll let you call in.
Yeah, it's true.
If what you had was such groundbreaking information, you wouldn't get on the air on the government Patsy show.
Yeah, that's true. We don't screen calls out on this program, much to the chagrin of our consultants and you know, some of the people who might be, I guess, critical of. Sometimes you get a bad call when you do that.
Well, there's an older theory in radio that you don't let callers just call in and talk about whatever.
But that's
what
we do. That's what the show's sort of concept is, and it was formed because I, as a talk radio listener, was frustrated by the idea that these talk show hosts seem to have this ironclad control over the content that went out on their show, and I didn't like that as a caller.
They spend all the time, "Oh, I love you. We out here in Topeka just think you're so great, Ian."
I hate that stuff.
"Oh God, dittos to you, Ian, and everything you guys say. It's awesome. Do you think you could come out and be best man at our wedding?" I mean, just this drivel that the airwaves are just full of.
Let freedom ring.
Free Talk Live might every once in a while get derailed by a caller. Absolutely. There's no doubt about it, or we'll have a bad caller. But every one of those calls is bad.
Sean, you're a great American.
It's just these people talking about how awesome the host is.
I wouldn't be able to live with myself.
"Hey, Ian,
that show.
You're a bloated megalomaniac. Can we talk about the issues for a minute?"
Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. There's an issue coming up here, and that is your right to bear arms. Think you have a right? Well, not if you're asking for permission. And our friend Derrick J. Freeman will tell a story.
"Has this ever happened to you? You're applying for some type of a loan, whether online or in person. When it's time to hit submit, your nerves spike because you're not sure you'll get the approval you seek. There's a different way to approach life. It's called Credit Success Secrets Revealed. Credit Success Secrets Revealed is a revolutionized step-by-step system that you can follow to get all the credit you desire today. We're talking about secured and unsecured credit, car leases, credit cards, and cash. Call 800-568-8960. Credit Success Secrets Revealed works no matter what your current situation, whether you've had bad credit, never had credit, or looking for some business credit or any type of credit. Please call 800-568-8960. We don't take any personal information. Your personal information is way too valuable to trust to a third-party email or a website that doesn't answer the phone. At Credit Success Secrets Revealed, we show you step-by-step what to place into the financial computer systems that control your credibility in the marketplace today. We practically fill out the forms for you. Credit Success Secrets Revealed works 100% of the time. Call now, 800-568-8960. That's 800-568-8960, 800-568-8960.
No! That's the sound your brain makes when you realize you're buying something and forgot the coupon. Online or in a store, knowing that you're missing a deal is the worst. You need the app from RetailMeNot right now. Get thousands of coupons from 50,000 stores like Kohl's, Domino's, Best Buy, and more with crazy deals like 60% off, free shipping, and free gifts with purchase. You can get a text invite to download the RetailMeNot app 100% free right now for Apple or Android. Just text the code UPDATE to 42767. Then just show your phone at checkout to save. It literally couldn't be easier. It's 2015. Keep your coupons in your phone. Stop what you're doing and text UPDATE to 42767. Listeners will get a text with a link to download it 100% free. Never forget another coupon again. Text the code UPDATE to 42767 right now. That's UPDATE to 42767. Message and data rates may apply. For terms and privacy, visit RetailMeNot.com.
Understanding your credit score is the first step towards managing and improving it. This is Charlie Sundstrom with your Van Dyke Mortgage Minute. The most influential component of your credit score is your payment history. Almost equally as important is the amount you owe on credit accounts. Also impacting your score, but to a lesser degree, are the length of time you've utilized your credit, the number of new accounts, credit inquiries, and your various types of credit accounts. To help achieve or maintain a healthy credit score, have a system set up to assure your bills are always paid on time. Don't max out your cards. It's better to have a high credit limit with a low balance. Never close old accounts. The age of these can actually help your credit score. But don't be afraid to use your credit. You need several accounts in order to have a credit score. Just keep the corresponding payments within your means. For your mortgage pre-approval and refi needs, start by visiting VanDykeMortgage.com.
Corporate NMLS 3035. Van Dyke Mortgage is an equal housing lender. Charlie Sundstrom, NMLS 134251.
LRN
LRN.fm is proud to announce our official listening apps for Android and iOS devices. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for LRN.fm in the Android or Apple app stores. Please download, rate it 5 stars, then share the link on social media, and let your friends and family know how you're listening to LRN.fm. Download it now, free at apps.lrn.fm. That's apps.lrn.fm.
Did you know that Free Aid is a mutual aid, educational, and networking organization? At Free Aid, we support volunteers who provide first aid, we do outreach to the public about health and safety, and we bring together medically skilled freedom lovers. Free Aid is made possible by your generous support. Donors can receive great gifts like first aid kits, t-shirts, silver dime cards, and hoodies. The Free Aid Silver Dime Card Project is sponsored in part by Roberts & Roberts Brokerage, Freedom's Phoenix, and Don't Tread on Meme. Visit fr33aid.com.
You can put the Liberty Radio Network on the air in your area. Visit broadcast.lrn.fm to learn how. Broadcast.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. You can join us here on the radio waves and bring up whatever happens to be on your mind. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Join us online. Drop by freetalklive.com. Enjoy the features you'll find there on the site. Once again, freetalklive.com. Coming up here October 29th and 30th. We're about a month away now from the Bitcoin Investor Conference, the first one ever. It's going to be happening in Vegas at the beautiful D Hotel.
I'm excited. We're going to be doing Free Talk Live from Las Vegas for the first time ever.
Wow, and that is exciting.
It's going to be a lot of fun to be out there. Yeah.
Bitcoininvestor.com. You can go get your tickets there right now. You're not going to want to miss being around some of the movers and the shakers in the Bitcoin industry, including Paul Pui, Joseph von Perling, Bitcoin Bell, Tone Vase, Trace Mayer, Stephen Michaels, and more. You can go to bitcoininvestor.com to learn about the event. It's happening October 29th and 30th. And come on out and meet Mark, and he'll be broadcasting live. Bitcoininvestor.com as we continue here. Here is the story from our friend, former co-host Derrick J. Freeman. He's also the host of Cop Block Radio and Flaming Freedom, as well as sometime co-host on Freedom Fiends. Great, talented guy who I had the pleasure of calling my roommate for a long period of time here in Keene. And he's a Free State Project early mover, and hopefully we'll be seeing him back here in New Hampshire one of these days, despite the terrible news that he received from the New Hampshire Supreme Court regarding his petition to receive a concealed weapons permit. Now, in some states, they have what's called a shall issue permit.
Right.
And the term shall issue suggests
that they shall issue it.
That they shall issue it when you request it. That you go,
you fit the criteria, they issue it.
Yeah. Unfortunately, at least in New Hampshire, there's one pesky little word in there that the legislature types put in that is essentially a huge loophole that allows the government to do whatever they want and not issue you a permit if they decide they don't like you. If they decide that you are, in their terminology, unsuitable. Are you an unsuitable person?
Right. So they decide that. You know, in this case, they did it because of arrests, but there were no felony arrests. It wasn't a clear criteria. It's just somebody making up their mind that you're unsuitable.
In a piece over on his blog, TheDerrickJ.com.
This is often what I'm scared of when they say things like, well, we need to check and see if people are mentally stable before they get their firearms license. Mm-hmm. Well, if you're mentally stable, unstable, you'd think you'd have a criminal record by the time you were able to buy a handgun. But otherwise, you're just asking people to guess whether somebody's stable or not. And in this case, was it the police chief?
The police chief was the first person to deny him the permit. It was then upheld by district court judge Burke, and then further upheld by the Supreme Court in New Hampshire.
The police chief decided that he was unsuitable for whatever reason the police chief decided, mm-hmm. and that's it. There's really no check and balance on this.
No, there's the right to appeal.
The court system didn't decide whether the police chief was right or not. They just decided whether or not he could make that decision.
You haven't read the three-page decision, correct?
I don't. Which is the brand new one?
Yeah.
No.
Okay. Well, then I don't think you should go out on that limb. So the Supreme Court did assess the claims of the lower court and therefore the police chief, and they determined basically that that they agreed with the initial assessment by the police chief that Derrick was unsuitable.
I see.
For this. So I'm going to get into the details here from Derrick's own writing over at freekeen.com and his blog, thederrickj.com. But first, John is in Arizona listening to K-Talks. Hello, John.
Good evening, guys. Welcome, how sir. Are you?
Excellent. Go ahead, sir.
I was calling in regards to a caller a little while ago that got the ticket over the inspection sticker.
Yeah.
And he indicated that he had a bunch of bumper stickers on his car regarding liberty.
Yeah, he did say that.
I think that might, you know, I've heard people who have a bunch of bumper stickers often talk about how they think that they're targeted.
Exactly. Well, you know what? That guy received a contempt of cop ticket. I'm retired from law enforcement in California over 30 years. He got him a contempt of cop ticket. He had all these stickers on his back bumper. He got pulled over. He did the right thing about pulling into the bakery parking lot to get off the roadway.
Yeah, I wanted to ask you about that. You know, instead of pulling over on the road, he pulls into a parking lot.
He did the right thing there. Excuse me. Well, when the policeman walked up, and then he spouts off, I'm recording you. Excuse me, I had a frog in my throat there. He bought him a contempt of cop ticket. He should have never been cited for the... He should have never been cited for failure to pull over because he did pull over. He just picked the spot for his safety and the safety of the policeman that
well,
stopped him.
Well, you know as well as we do that the cops can cite you for all manner of different things, and then, you know, some of them are going to get dropped by the prosecutor or the court, and there's no penalty for the cop for writing failure to pull. Even if the guy in the car did pull over and he was fully within the way the code was written, the way the statutes were written, it's no skin off the cop's back to just go ahead and tack an extra charge on, right?
Well, you know, not really.
Yeah, exactly.
It appeared to me that he was looking to pick a fight with that policeman. When as soon as the copper walked up on the car, he says, "I'm recording you."
That's not picking a fight, man. That's just you're exercising your rights. That's informing the officer that he better be on his best
behavior.
They're
not used to it.
I'm not arguing with you, okay?
Yeah.
I'm just saying that just set the stage for him to. For him to receive the ticket.
I see what you're saying, but that's not a reason to not record the police, right? Like, it's important to record the cops.
Well, you know, there's a lot of this going on in our country right now with citizens recording the behavior of policemen.
Mm-hmm.
Are you with me?
Yeah, absolutely. I support it. I encourage it.
Okay. Just think of any employee in any business that where a citizen would walk in to conduct business. And the person that walks in the door immediately turns on their camera phone and starts recording. That just sets the bad tone.
I see what you're saying.
I think it certainly could set a bad tone.
But it's different. It's different as far as, you know, if I'm walking into private business, then I should be more respectful of recording the people in there because it's a privately run business and they're not threatening me to come into their store. When a man pulls you over as a police officer, when a uniformed man with a car and a gun forces you to the side of the road, he has been the one who has put the whole encounter on a negative footing because he's threatening you in the first place. And so, you know, if you don't pull over, they'll run you off the road, possibly shoot you and kill you. And so that's why it's completely appropriate to respond with a video camera to these people.
I would have never done that, but I have the experience of being on the law enforcement side of an issue. And I didn't call your station to pick a fight. I was just sharing an opinion.
I don't feel like I'm fighting with you. We're just having a discussion. I thank you for the call tonight,
Wait,
John.
I've got one more question.
Okay, go ahead.
So I've got a video camera in my car that runs all the time. It's not me holding a camera up, and I get where you're coming from on this one, but I'm just sort of asking. If a police officer comes to a car and you've got this equipment that's just sort of running in your car on a regular basis, like they have on theirs, do you think that that's as confronting for them?
No, not at all.
Yeah, I wouldn't think so either.
Thanks, John, for your call tonight. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. Look, if you want to keep your head down and not stir any trouble, then yeah, just be real obedient. but I think you should stand up for your rights.
Healthy, organic, fresh fish, robust, mouth-watering vegetables, all from your home. It's called aquaponics. This brilliant, self-sustaining protein and veggie system is perfect for year-round growing. Know exactly where your food is coming from. AquaponicsSource.com is the one-stop shop for all your needs. Fish, fish food, plumbing, full systems, classes, and more. Learn to build your own system. Go to AquaponicsSource.com for a free guide to aquaponics. That's AquaponicsSource.com.
Paid non-attorney spokesperson Adam Pulaski of the Pulaski Law Firm with principal office in Houston, Texas is the attorney responsible for the content of this ad. This ad is not legal advice, and the choice of a lawyer should not be based solely upon advertisement. Services may not be available in all states.
Attention Xarelto users. If you or a loved one took Xarelto and suffered a serious bleeding event, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Xarelto is a popular prescription blood thinner used to prevent blood clots and protect patients from strokes. These serious bleeding events have led to numerous cases of hospitalization and even death. Phone lines are open 24/7. Call 800-261-0937. That's 800-261-0937.
Keenvention is coming up fast, October 30th through November 1st. Get your tickets now at keenvention.info. Keenvention is an intimate event where you can meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire, including Oathkeeper Chris Reitman, Libertarian presidential candidate Daryl W. Perry, illegal Uber driver Christopher David, NeoCash Radio's Dr. Darren Tapp, State Representative Mike Silvia, rated an A-plus by the NHLA, The Seditious Sirens, The Rebel Love Show's Rob Mathias, Tech Guru Brian Sovereign, Cop Blocker J.P. Freeman, New Mover Dr. Taryn Lupo, longtime political activist Dennis Goddard, Church of the Invisible Hand Minister Rich Paul, Shire Dude, and dozens more. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or with Bitcoin. That includes access to the Hallowkeen costume dance party. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more speaker announcements, or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, Mark, at freetalklive.com.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more.
It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
Do you sometimes feel that healthy eating can be a lot of work with very little reward? Well, no need to worry any longer. Here are the Onion's tips for healthy eating. First, identify your weaknesses, and then condition yourself to avoid problem foods by associating them with deceased relatives, unrequited loves, and traumatic events. Remember, alcohol is a source of empty calories, so be sure to keep your drinking under control. Unless you're really f***ing stressed out. Like if something shitty happens at work, or if your cat gets hit by a car. If you find yourself suddenly craving a fatty food, let yourself enjoy the best of both worlds. Tape a slice of ham to your tongue and slowly absorb the taste throughout the day without swallowing. Stay motivated by paying yourself $1 every day until you meet your weight loss goals. At the end of 10 years' time, spend that cash on a cosmetic operation of your choice. There, now you're ready to begin your new healthy lifestyle.
This is the Onion News Network.
You can connect with the Liberty Radio Network via our Facebook page at facebook.lrn.fm. That's facebook.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. You may join us here on the radio waves. Toll free number for you is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us on our website. Just drop on by freetalklive.com. With you in the studio, you've got me, Ian.
And me, Mark.
And so I just realized I never turned the cam on tonight. Sorry about that, everybody who was trying to watch the cam. It's now there. You can now watch the cam at cam.freetalklive.com.
Yeah, thanks, buddy.
Well, you know, it's free. You can get what you pay for.
That is not the attitude of a person who runs a business. Yeah, that's an incentive for people to listen to the show. It's not free. It's value added.
Yeah, okay, whatever. Well, it's free, so you don't get to complain too much. 855-450-FREE is our number. We've got Skype as well. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. Let's go to the phones and your thoughts. I know, Mark, you wanted to continue to discuss recording the police. We'll get into that. But first, Mika or Micah is on the line in Montana. Maybe Micah, you're on Free Talk Live.
That's it.
Excellent.
Yep. And if you go over the Swedish version, you can say Mika. So,
all right.
Yeah, I just wanted to call in and tell you I appreciated your conversation last night on the Blood Moons. And I believe it was Mark that made a comment about the Christian belief of preterism, which briefly just sees all of the New Testament prophecies fulfilled in the destruction of Jerusalem in AD 70. And I kind of wish that would have gone a little bit farther along in the conversation. What I wanted to point out real quick is that within the preterist movement, Christianity is moving into a libertarian framework because within traditional Christianity, the need for a state that has the monopoly use of force is found within the idea that man is a fallen creature and that Christ hasn't come back yet. So what's happening is within these Christian sects that are going into preterist theology, they're realizing that that has all come to an end and that there is no longer any need for a state in the fact of waiting for Christ to come back, where there has to be men, you know, ruling over other men in his stead. So it's kind of analogous to when the reformers came along, they essentially replaced the divine right of the king with the divine right of the democracy, kind of that idea. But the other thing I wanted to mention, too, is that this is super important for the liberty movement because John Hagee, while he's more of an extremist view, he does represent the majority of the right-wing Christians. So when you get Christians
in many ways,
typically,
this is the guy. This John Hagee is this pastor who believed the Blood Moon was going to mean some sort of thing was going to happen, some kind of terrible climactic event.
Well, it was supposed to actually begin in tears and end in triumph. So actually, something triumphant, I think, is supposed to occur. I'm not sure what the tears were.
Well, what he has is that he has it tied to the modern nation state of Israel, and this is where you get the huge Israel lobby within the right wing, which actually is calling for wars in the Middle East because they believe that Israel, the modern state of Israel, is still God's chosen people. And so the Blood Moons are supposed to initiate some type of Armageddon, and it's interesting because the fundamentalist Muslims in the Middle East have the exact same kind of Armageddon end times mentality. Not the more secular Muslims, but the more fundamentalists that we tend to arm. And so I think the liberty movement, as far as being more appealing to Christians, I think they can take some good lessons and say, hey, listen, you know, we understand you're a Christian, and we know you like Ron Paul, except you don't like his philosophy on foreign intervention, but what about looking at a different, you know, theology that still fits within your framework that would allow you to be consistent across the board? And I think that would be a great thing for the liberty community to kind of engage with Christians in, because there's a huge amount of Christians that will never become libertarians just for this fact that, well, we have to have a government because Christ hasn't come back yet. And by the way, Israel, we have to protect because we're America and we're God's chosen people to protect Israel until the Armageddon comes. And all this nonsense.
I mean, when the hell did the Christ ever say, you guys need a government while I'm gone? I mean, that didn't happen.
In Romans, it said that the rulers are placed above you and that they are terrible or something like that. But terrible in the sense of, you don't want to be on their bad side. So to some extent, the Bible said that in Romans. That's Paul. Now, I'll make my arguments against Paul, to anybody particularly wants to hear them. Most people don't. But I've heard lots of people make this claim as far as there's ways that we can massage the message. And I like preterism. I suspect I wouldn't be nearly as damaged by Christianity if that was the sort of Christianity that I was taught. But you know, the difficulty is that I just can't address those issues because I don't have enough knowledge of, say, preterism. I'm not a preterist teacher, a preterist preacher. And so, you know, the liberty movement, I encourage, we don't tell people what to think on Free Talk Live. All we say is that human freedom is a value that that we should purport. So, yes, I agree with you completely. I just don't know what to do to further your philosophy.
Well, I appreciate you mentioning it last night on the conversation. I can't listen live. I'm on a delay, and then I usually listen on my podcast while I'm working throughout the day. And I think that there are a lot of things that you guys have done great, and I really appreciate all the work that you've done. My point when I talk to people that are kind of, whether in Christian circles, which I run in as well as libertarian circles, I'm trying to bring those two together and say, hey, wait a minute. There is a Christian theology that actually is a theology that supports the libertarian philosophy.
There is, and there are a lot of Christian libertarians that
sure
I've met.
Are.
Thank you for the call tonight, Micah. And we're seeing some more of them move here to New Hampshire as well. And now, there are plenty of libertarian atheists and all manner of different libertarian, you know, there's the Muslims for Liberty and all manner of different religions.
They seem to get along just fine
within the liberty movement. And they really do. Yeah. And they're very respectful, the Christians that are at least up here in New Hampshire, as far as the Free Staters, the liberty activists that are here. Varen Swearingen, who's the former president of the Free State Project, is a big time Christian with his family. And he and I get along just fine. I mean, it's great.
They interface with their church, and you don't go to their church, so you don't interface with them in that way.
And they're never pushy about it, you know, like the religious folks here, the Christian folks, to be more specific.
Yeah, I don't find that to be the case. Yeah.
Toll-free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Of course, Mark, you and I are involved in the Shire Free Church, which is an interfaith group of folks who might believe different things about theology that have come together under the banner of getting the state out of churches and having a church that is a non-state church, not worshiping the state higher than or alongside of their own God. That's one of the kind of the premises behind the Shire Free Church.
Yeah, well, not only that, but I mean, I also am of the opinion that, you know, like you're going to have whatever opinion you have about your God and the way that, you know, that speaks to you or whatever. But the God has a value of human freedom. Like, this is important and integral to you know, God's interface with man, that morality can't exist without you know, people being able to choose between sort of doing the right thing and doing the wrong thing. So governments don't have a role in that. So that's what my main you know, thrust in being involved with the Shire Free Church is.
Our toll-free number tonight, allowing you to bring up whatever happens to be on your mind, it's 855-450-FREE. Whether it's theology or gun rights, you can bring up anything here on Free Talk Live. We've also got Skype. It's Skype username lrn.fm. Our friend Derrick J. Freeman writes in his blog post that is at the top of freekeen.com right now, "I got a sad letter from my attorney this week," writes Derrick. He says he informed me that the Supreme Court of New Hampshire upheld the lower court's decision to deny my application for a license to carry a handgun discreetly. You can read the decision here. And then he links to the 3-page long Supreme Court decision.
As though Derrick J. has ever done anything discreetly.
And he says, "Well, that was fun. Thanks for playing. Please remember to tip your waitress on the way out. $5,000 in legal fees, endless
wow.
hours spent in and out of various courts. And for what? A goose egg. Nothing. No justice. No rights. No freedom. This sucks." We'll continue with his comments here. This is Free Talk Live. Currency is too important a thing to be left in the hands of government bureaucrats, especially when billions of dollars can be created with the swipe of a pen. Overstock.com supports the cryptocurrency movement because it returns the power of an inflation-proof form of money to the people, where it belongs. Did you know that you can use Bitcoin to pay for anything Overstock.com sells while enjoying free shipping on orders of 0.211 Bitcoin or more? If you support freedom and the cryptocurrency movement, you should support Overstock.com.
Flu season starts with all kinds of symptoms. At Walmart, we can help you be prepared before they show up with products like Mucinex to help relieve chest congestion and Delsym to help silence coughs for 12 hours. You'll also want to be ready with Sudafed PE to relieve sinus congestion and pressure. and Motrin for body aches and to reduce fever. So don't wait until the symptoms have already started. Be prepared for flu season this year. Stock up on everything you need at Walmart.
Use all products as directed.
No way. Is that a real bullet necklace?
No, it's a 9mm bullet necklace with matching earrings, you'll notice.
Those are awesome. Where'd you get them?
Dave found them at PatriotNecklace.com.
Wow.
They have a variety of calibers and necklaces and earrings and keychains.
PatriotNecklace.com?
PatriotNecklace.com.
Your choice of caliber bullet includes a rugged American-made stainless steel dog tag chain. A percentage of every sale goes to military and service-related charities. And get a discount by entering GCN at checkout. Show your patriotism and support our troops with a bullet necklace from PatriotNecklace.com.
Hi, I'm Rick Osick with Famous Footwear. Did you know that premature birth is the number one killer of babies? That's why we support the March of Dimes in the fight against premature birth. Join us in supporting cutting-edge research, treatment programs, and outreach to help moms have full-term pregnancies and healthy babies. Learn how you can help save babies' lives at marchofdimes.org.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 85% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. If you're a regular reader of FreeKeene.com, you know there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at FreeKeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at FreeKeene.com. That's FreeKeene.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com. If there was a place that liberty-minded people had been elected to political positions and were rolling back government, would you move there? If freedom lovers had secured a 20% voting bloc and can veto most bad bills, would you move? Well, the time has come to sign the pledge at freestateproject.org. These things have happened in New Hampshire, and you can join us and help. freestateproject.org. Sign up now at freestateproject.org.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. Our friend Derrick J. Freeman denied his supposed right to protect himself, to bear arms. In this case, to conceal carry those arms. We'll tell you more about what happened to him here in a Supreme Court case here in New Hampshire. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. You've heard about shall issue? Well, at least here, it's total BS. Because they can deny that shall issue permit so long as they determine that you are unsuitable. That's the legal term here that allows them to just, you know, push whatever they want through the eye of a needle. I mean, it's just ridiculous. All they have to do is just claim that you're unsuitable and give some sort of, you know, lame-o reason as to why. We'll give you some of their reasons why they think our friend Derrick J., who's entirely peaceful and responsible with his firearms, is unsuitable. He can carry them openly. So it's not like he's being told he can't have a gun. It's not like he's being told...
He just can't put the gun under a coat.
Correct. Or go into his car with it, apparently. With it loaded, at least, as I understand it. So we'll get into more of that. Also, if you want to win $1,000 worth of Bitcoin, here's how you do it. You go to forum.bitcoin.com. You register for an account. It's free. And then you start posting on the Bitcoin forum. Now, I guess what happened was there used to be a really popular, I mean, there still is, there's a really popular Bitcoin forum out there that is, I think, Bitcoin Talk. But apparently there has been some censorship going on there, and our friend Roger Ver is none too happy about that. So he has just taken matters into his own hands rather than complaining at the Bitcoin Talk forum and trying to change the policy from inside of the forum. He's just gone ahead and started his own darn Bitcoin forum, and he's got a better URL. It's forum.bitcoin.com. You can just go there and start posting, and the most appreciated forum post basically around the end of the year. So you get some time here, but posting sooner rather than later is probably a good thing. The most appreciated of the forum posts is going to be the author of that post will be awarded $1,000 worth of Bitcoin. And it's that simple. So go and get interactive there. It's I guess the criteria here is that it'll be by January 1st or when the forum hits 10,000 users, whichever of those is first. So go to forum.bitcoin.com. Our toll-free number, and by the way, bitcoin.com, just on its own without the forum, bitcoin.com, great website to point people to who might be new to the ideas of Bitcoin to kind of pitch them on the idea of Bitcoin. That's basically the purpose of the site. So check it out. Ian and Mark here in the studio with you tonight. Derrick J. Freeman, our friend and former co-host, has been denied his supposed right to conceal carry a firearm in a supposedly shall-issue state. And I'm going to continue his blog post from freekeen.com. It's also over on his site, thederrickj.com. He says, these cross-dressing lawyers claim that I am unsuitable to conceal a firearm because I have been involved in two scuffles with law enforcers. Never mind that they attacked me. Never mind that I always have been peaceful. Never mind that I can still legally own and carry a gun. I just can't put it in my pocket, wear a coat over it, or step in my car with it. Sure, that makes sense, he says.
It makes no sense at all. I mean, if you're going to let a person carry a gun, then having them unload it every time they get into a car, and then presumably load it when they get out of the car.
That will look a little scary to people.
That's unsafe, and that's going to make people uncomfortable.
Yep. He says, my only takeaway from this 15-month ordeal is that so-called rights are a lie. If your freedoms can be restricted by state agents because of personal prejudice, then they are not rights. The whole point of a license is to restrict a person's natural freedom and then sell it back to him, or in my case, refuse to sell it back at all. The ruling doesn't have to make sense. The judges have the power of infinite force on their side, and while they may claim that might does not make right, that is precisely how they operate. And I'd like to add in here the recollection of what happened to Derrick J as far as the police chief's excuses and reasons for denying Derrick the right to conceal carry, or denying him his license to conceal carry. He basically said that Derrick shouldn't be able to conceal carry because he doesn't respect the police enough. That was his reason for not granting it to him.
It doesn't seem reasonable that you would demand respect, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You did not respect us enough. You made a movie, Victimless Crime Spree, where you disrespect the police and you, you know, you don't do everything that we say when we say to do it. So therefore, you shouldn't be able to defend yourself. That's what's happening here. And that's one of the reasons why he was called unsuitable. And then these judges are backing this guy up. He says these people have no shame, no dignity, and no honor. If they did, they would respect my right as a human being to defend myself. And they wouldn't stand in my way of exercising my natural freedoms. But they do, at every opportunity. When I've asked permission of a bureaucrat, the answer undoubtedly comes back, no, you can't. Well, why?
It does seem to be what they do.
Because am I a bad man? Because I am a bad man? No, he says. Simply because the people with the power don't like that I don't respect their supposed authority. So what now? The answer is obvious to everyone with a freed mind in his head. Ignore these sociopaths who imagine that they own me and peacefully do as I please. Gandhi said the only tyrant I accept is the still, small voice within me. Does their ruling mean that I can't discreetly carry my gun? Certainly not. I'm a free man, free to live my life and use my property so long as I'm not infringing on the rights of others. But Derrick, you ask, why did you apply in the first place if you were only going to ignore the ruling anyway? Well, the answer is because I was lied to. I was told that New Hampshire is a shall-issue state, and that it would be easy. It's just $10 and a trip to the police department, they said. That, you can see, is not true. I fit the criteria for a concealed carry license, except that the man who called himself the chief used his moment of power to deny me on his way out the door.
He's gone, too.
As a final F-U before retiring. There will be no consequences for him, nor will there be any consequences for the criminal judges and law enforcers who allow this type of evil to continue. Not just against me, but against the countless others without a voice. Without the $5,000 to drop on an attorney, I would, and that was at reduced rates, by the way.
Yeah.
Without the popular blog, without the verbal skills or the time to spend articulating their story of injustice. Well, then let this be my consolation. That you have not stopped me. You have only fueled my passion for justice. I will long outlive you gray-haired tyrants, and I will spend every single waking second of my time on this earth influencing and inspiring young minds with my courage, creativity, and undying commitment to human freedom until the world recognizes you for the thoughtless, controlling brutes you are. You may beat me, cage me, and deny me the freedom that is my birthright, but you will never have my obedience. And that's from our friend Derrick J. Freeman.
Ultimately, that's what they want. Ultimately, is they want you not to just do it, but to smile while you do it. And anything less than that is it's criminal.
He probably did smile when he went down and filled out the application. Derrick is a very friendly, affable individual who always has a smile on his face, or very frequently does. But the thing is that he wasn't obedient enough before that, Mark.
Yeah.
He was obediently going ahead and trying to go through the process and get the darn official piece of paper from the state of New Hampshire, as countless other people have been able to do. But because they knew who he was, and because he had not done everything the police had demanded of him in the past, he was denied.
Now, he doesn't live here any longer, so he's under whatever rule that there is in California and San Francisco, which I suspect makes New Hampshire look pretty good, frankly. But
there's no doubt New Hampshire is one of the better states, but this just goes to show that these bureaucrats will take whatever power they can get.
But let me ask you this. So the rules as they have been handed down at this point, could he simply go to another town in New Hampshire and get this done, or would that now be a violation of these rulings?
That's an interesting question. Rich Paul looked at the court's decision. It's a relatively short three-page decision by the Supreme Court. And Rich seems to believe that the way the decision was written essentially means that it's an open for interpretation by the local police chiefs and judges. So if there's a different police chief or a different judge who hears the case and decides that Derrick is suitable, essentially this is not precedent on Derrick.
Okay,
so there would be nothing at all.
They're basically the judges were saying that it's okay that the police chief ruled this way.
Yeah,
but if another police chief decides to rule another way, then it's fine because he's not barred by law from having a concealed carry permit. So
yeah,
there you go.
And so essentially one of the things that they say in the ruling is that the Supreme Court, they rely on the trial judge to be the determiner of fact.
Okay.
So if your trial judge is biased as hell against you, like you could argue Judge Burke is here in Keene.
He's certainly seen Derrick plenty.
You could argue then my point here is that the Supreme Court will not look anew at the evidence in the case. They presume the trial judge got it right in looking at the evidence. And in this case, the Supreme Court, they claimed that, well, Derrick had a tussle or a scuffle a couple times with a cop, so therefore he's not suitable to have a firearm, even though the cops attacked Derrick.
If worst comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com. If you expect secure, privacy-oriented services and real human support from your web hosting provider, choose Virtual Space International. From domain names and SSL certificates to offshore banking accounts, Virtual Space International has been the all-in-one, multi-language solution for over 25 years. And satisfaction is guaranteed or your money back. We even accept Bitcoin. Find out how to get 50% off for life at SaveTimeHosting.com.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Boost Kit Essentials Nutritionally Complete Drink, providing your picky eater with essential nutrition and great taste in one drink. Visit us at kitessentials.com. To make sure your kids eat healthy, follow the 5-a-day plan. Serve 3 servings of vegetables and 2 servings of fruit daily. Remember, a serving could just mean a piece of fruit or a half cup of veggies. If your kids are picky eaters, ask a nutritionist about other sources. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number 3 is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keenan, the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Monday, September 28th, 2015. Silver is trading at $14.70 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,132 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $238. Antiwar.com reports early reports of the Islamic State trying to establish an affiliate in Afghanistan were mostly downplayed by the U.S. and other Western powers, who believed the group to be little more than a handful of disaffiliated Taliban commanders trying to get international attention. That the rare the Islamic State activity was all fighting against the Taliban rivals seemed to support that. Sunday, the Islamic State gunmen attacked a police checkpoint in Nangarhar, killing 3 and wounding 8 in the first real attack against the Afghan security force. The attack comes amid reports of a growing the Islamic State influence across the nation and a huge recruitment effort spanning 25 provinces. Indeed, the latest report suggests that only about 10% of the Islamic State force inside Afghanistan is Taliban defectors, and that the group's parent organization in Iraq and Syria has sent roughly 70 seasoned commanders to serve as the leadership core of this growing branch. The ability to recruit Taliban defectors might be growing with the latest leadership disputes in that group, but the ability of the Islamic State to form an almost entirely new group with so little crossover with a Taliban insurgency that's been in place for decades suggests they are resonating with a whole new group of people and could be a hugely complicating matter in the ongoing occupation of Afghanistan.
For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
UPI reports President Obama and Raul Castro will meet Tuesday at the United Nations to discuss the developing relationship between the United States and Cuba. In Cuba's first UN General Assembly since the two countries renewed diplomatic relations, the White House said Obama will hold a bilateral meeting with Castro. This is the second face-to-face between Obama and Castro since diplomatic relations were restored in late 2014. They also met in April at the Summit of the Americas meeting in Panama and have spoken by phone. Ben Rhodes, Obama's Deputy National Security Advisor for Strategic Communications, called Castro's UN visit very significant and a symbol we're in a new era of U.S.-Cuba relations. On Friday, he met with several members of Congress who support the renewed relations. While at the United Nations, Obama will meet with the President of Kazakhstan, Prime Minister of India, and possibly Vladimir Putin to discuss topics that include concerns about a Russian military buildup in Syria. Are you an advocate for free market money? Do you promote Bitcoin as an alternative in a fiat-centric world? Then you need Spendabit in your arsenal, the search engine for things you can buy with Bitcoin. Spendabit aggregates millions of products from thousands of Bitcoin-enabled merchants. Keep your money in the free economy. Visit spendabit.co today. Bitcoin merchants, ask about our merchant suite to reach even more customers. Spendabit.co. Reuters reports separatists on Sunday won a clear majority of seats in Catalonia's parliament in an election that sets the region on a collision course with Spain's central government over independence. With secessionist parties securing 72 out of 135 seats in the region of 7.5 million people, that includes Barcelona, acting regional government head Artur Mas told reporters Catalans have voted yes to independence. The strong pro-independence showing dealt a blow to Spanish Prime Minister Mariano Rajoy 3 months before a national election. His center-right government, which has opposed attempts to hold a referendum on secession, has called the separatist plan a nonsense and vowed to block it in court. The main secessionist group, Together for Yes, won 62 seats, while the smaller leftist CUP party earned 10 seats. Both had said before the vote that such a result would allow them to unilaterally declare independence within 18 months, under a plan that would see the new Catalan authorities approving their own constitution and building institutions like an army, central bank, and judicial system. Mas said a democratic mandate now exists to move forward with independence. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
The dangerous winter storm Rocky is expected to pummel the Midwest throughout the day, with meteorologists predicting the blizzard will hit Kevin Hodges of Joliet, Illinois, the hardest, given the way his year's been going.
Yeah, we're stocking up on everything. I think school's going to be canceled. We're just glad we're not Kevin right now.
Joining us now is Jordan Blake in Chicago. Hello, Jordan. Just how crippling will this storm be for Kevin?
Well, we've already seen a lot of damage. A motorist in Kansas trapped in their cars on the freeway. That's nothing compared to the emotional damage Hodges can expect. Having to deal with a sick cat, frustrating new hours at work, and a confusing breakup all in the past 6 months.
You know, we're getting reports that he recently loaned $600 to a friend who has no intention of paying him back and slammed his finger in a car door last month. Does the National Weather Service have any advice for Kevin today?
Not much he can do. This guy is really vulnerable right now. Authorities are recommending that he just stay indoors and think about his mistakes.
That sounds like good advice. You know, he looks like a real sad piece of Stay warm out there, Jordan.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live.
It's Free Talk Live. You can join us toll free. 855-450-FREE allows you to comment on the status of gun rights in America, your right to defend yourself, not just with guns, but swords and knives and blowguns and whatever it is that you feel is appropriate. You should be able to do that. And some states, you can't do much at all in the way of defending yourself. New Hampshire, one of the better states, probably in the top five or six states as far as your gun freedom rights are considered here in New Hampshire. Vermont and Alaska are better. I think Arizona and Maine are now better as well. I think they've had some reform in recent years in those two states that have allowed for what is called constitutional carry, meaning that you don't have to ask government permission to conceal carry a gun. New Hampshire doesn't have that, so we're working on getting there, and that's one of the reasons why the Free State Project is such an important idea, is getting liberty-minded folks to converge in one geographic area so we can actually advance liberty in our lifetime instead of struggling to just, you know, keep the status quo, which is what most libertarians do all around the country, and of course they fail miserably because there just aren't enough of them. But some people will say, well, look, you know, you guys want everybody to move to New Hampshire, but it's not the freest state when it comes to gun rights.
It's not
the freest state when it comes to marijuana.
It's not the freest state when it comes to most particular issues. I mean, seatbelts, and it's among them as far as income tax goes and sales tax and a few things like that. But the rankings are in, and it's pretty indisputable that over time New Hampshire comes in. It's been rated by Mercatus Center, the Freedom of the 50 States, as the freest state, and in some cases, you know, it's been beat out by other states. But over time,
Recently, it's number four on that list.
Number four recently, but that was during the, you know, a time when there was a lot of spending going on that those politicians have been kicked out. It's some time ago. Regardless, it doesn't really make a difference. I don't want to make excuses. I want to say that New Hampshire has ranked the best over time in that list.
But Mark, I mean, it does sound like excuses, right? You guys in New Hampshire, you don't have it together. Why shouldn't people who want gun rights just move to Vermont and the people who want to smoke pot move to Colorado?
Absolutely. That's what they should do. If the only freedom you care about is open, you know, concealed carry of your weapon, you should move to some place where you get that most that sort of freedom. If you care about smoking pot, then you should go somewhere where that's best for you. If you care about human freedom on the aggregate, as it is rated by people who rate these things, as opposed to just your particular wet finger in the air, then New Hampshire, the Free State Project, is the best thing going. There may be some better ideas out there. I mean, I've heard things floated. I'm interested in, speaking of floating, I'm interested in the idea of seasteading. I'm interested in the idea of Liberland, this place that's between Serbia and Croatia, this terra nullius. I'm interested in Bitcoin. Some people claim that Bitcoin is going to solve the problems of liberty.
That's something that's pretty big in New Hampshire, is Bitcoin. Now, look, in New Hampshire, we're behind the ball on the issue of marijuana. There's no doubt about that. We're pretty darn good on gun rights here, all things considered, compared to the rest of the other 48 contiguous and the 50 states in general. So, I mean, generally, New Hampshire is the best place to live. There's just a lot fewer things that the government does here than it does in other states. And you've also got the added benefit of the fact that thousands of libertarians and voluntarists and anarchists are moving here. That's something that none of those other states have. And the community that has already been created here because of that is, it's unmatchable. It can't be even come close to in any other place in the world.
The community is really something. You can live and work with people who believe like you do, and there's really, you know, there's nothing like that. Yeah, some people will claim that, well, that's not a great way to spread the ideas of liberty. We should go to the heart of socialism. Don't worry, we got plenty of socialists for you to chit-chat with if that's you want to do. Just move to Keene, New Hampshire with Ian.
Yeah, exactly. Bernie Sanders is actually pretty popular in New Hampshire, so there's plenty of socialists around.
A lot of people will point to things like that. Bernie Sanders is doing great in New Hampshire. Then how in the world can you say that the Free State Project is successful? Well, first off, I don't care who we send to Washington, D.C.
Yeah.
I've stopped caring. If you care about that, well, you know, I don't know. I don't have a good solution for you, but I'm really happy that we're sending the worst politicians in the state out of it.
Guess what? New Hampshire has Democrats and it has Republicans too.
Just like your state.
Yeah, and those people are not freedom-friendly people in general. Although the New Hampshire Democrats and New Hampshire Republicans are a little different than your typical Democrats and Republicans, I would say that on the aggregate, they are more freedom-friendly. Like, New Hampshire Democrats tend to be gun owners in a lot of cases. They like respect gun rights. New Hampshire Republicans voted for gay marriage. So, you can't really pigeonhole the traditional left-right paradigm here in the same way that you can elsewhere. And the other thing that's worth pointing out is there are more libertarian activists here, I think, than there are Republican activists, and then there are Democrat activists.
That's what that has been said. But one thing that's important to note is this is called the Free State Project.
That's right. There's
this is
work
not
to be
called
done.
The Free State. That's it.
Yeah.
Or the Free State Solution or the Free State Completed. It's called the Free State Project.
That's
if
right.
you think that you want – if there's a – if I need to provide you with a free place, then frankly, I don't think you deserve liberty in the sense that you're not willing to
you're
work
lazy.
For it.
Yeah, you're not willing to right? do anything.
I'm supposed to care about your liberty? No. You got to get here and work with other people.
And there is work to be done. But we've got a better starting point than most. Let's go to Richard. He's in Arizona listening to K-Talks. Hey, Richard.
Hi, how are you doing?
Great, hey, go ahead.
Interesting. You had a conversation earlier. You guys were talking about some religious things. And I heard a different talk show earlier today that was complaining about a school back east that was shutting the school down on a regular basis because of a Muslim holiday. And there were a lot of people that were very angry about that. And then they had interviewed one of the Muslim people, and they were saying that based on the way that they're allowing people to come across the border, that they think that they're going to be able to start creating a situation where we have to adhere to a Sharia law and all kinds of weird stuff. And I was just wondering, what's your take on that? Because if the police officer can take an American kid off the street and give him a ticket because he doesn't like his bumper sticker, why don't they do something about people that advocate that kind of activity?
Well, I don't think I'm not concerned with Sharia law in any way, shape, or form. The idea that you're going to take, first off, Sharia law isn't Muslim. It's not Islamic. People will conflate these two. Sharia law is the form of law that they have in the area where Islam is prevalent. But Sharia law is no more Muslim than our judicial system is Christian, if you know what I mean. Ian, you've read the Quran
from
back to forth.
That's not my understanding.
That's my understanding from speaking to Muslims all over the place. But let's forget that for a second.
Okay.
If people wish to adhere to Sharia law in the United States and they wish to make contracts in Sharia law, I think they should be able to do that. But the likelihood that you're going to somehow dismantle the U.S.'s judicial system, this entrenched judicial system, in order to institute some law from someplace else, it doesn't seem likely to me. If somebody thinks that that's going to happen, they're in for a long, slow haul get that done.
Now, I'll correct you here in a moment on Sharia law, Mark, but Richard, you were saying you thought someone should do something about people who want to follow Sharia law. Is that right?
Well, not necessarily. I was just thinking that in terms of them being able to, we're talking about freedom all the time, and they have the freedom to advocate overthrowing our government and our country, and we don't have any way to retaliate but nobody does. Why doesn't somebody argue with these people, tell them to cut that stuff out?
Well, I don't think that it's really hard to comment on these issues, because most of the people who are listening or who have heard a thing or two about Sharia law really don't know anything about it. We had Will Coley from Muslims for Liberty on the show in the past a number of times, and he has explained, if I'm recalling correctly, I've got a Wikipedia piece here in front of me, but Will pointed out the Sharia law covers things like, how you wash your feet in preparation for prayer. I mean, there are a lot of different areas of Sharia law. And the idea that Muslims want to impose that upon people who are not Muslims is unbelievable to me. It's not anything that any Muslim has ever said to me that they want to see happen. But I'll bring Richard back here, and we can continue the discussion, because I think it's an important one. 855-450-FREE. This is Free Talk Live.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to saveitpurse.com and open an account. Do this right now. Don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to saveitpurse.com right now, get signed up, and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 15 to 25% off of everything at Amazon through saveitpurse.com. It's saveitpurse.com.
My name is Bill Bonner, and I'm the president of the largest private news and research network in the world. And I paid for this airtime because I have an important message to the American people. There's a change coming that the government isn't telling you about. This change has deep implications for life in America, from where you shop to the doctors you visit and the family you want to protect. Look, I've made predictions like this before. Thing is, I was right then too. A few years ago, I warned that housing prices would collapse. They did. Before that, I warned that dot-com companies would crash. They did. Those who listened had a chance to save themselves. But this has nothing to do with the stock market. This will affect us all.
You can watch the video for free right now by going to disappearingwealth.com. Again, that's disappearingwealth.com.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies!
Jesus.
On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, the Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolf. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
Help get LRN.FM into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. Join us on the radio at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We've got Skype as well. It's Skype username lrn.fm. Tonight in studio, it's me, Ian.
And me, Mark.
And we're going to continue here with your calls and thoughts. Let's go to Richard, still with us, listening in Arizona to K-Talks. Richard, you expressed some concern about Sharia law and people wanting to implement that here in the United States. Is
yeah,
that
it looks
right?
Like I was completely wrong about Sharia law not being part of Islam. You know, I'm looking this up. This is what was told to me by a Muslim, but I guess I'm just wrong.
I think you're just misremembering it.
Yeah, that's possible, too.
I can't imagine a Muslim would have told you that Sharia law is not part of Islam.
Okay.
But what we have been told about Sharia law is that it covers a lot of stuff. Like, you know, this is their system for their religion. I've never once heard a Muslim tell me that, you know, and we've talked to them about this issue. You know, we've talked to the guys from Muslims for Liberty, for instance, Davi Barker and Will Coley. And this is just a private religious system. It's not something that that really would make any sense to apply to people who don't follow their religion.
It does deal with sort of contract law to some extent, though. So, I mean, if two people want to make an agreement, say, under Sharia law, they should be able to make a contract in any way they want. Right?
It does cover contracts, so no, it would depend on what the Sharia says about that, I think. Richard, go ahead with your thoughts.
The reason that I was concerned is because they were successful in having an American school shut down on a regular basis to celebrate a Muslim holiday for some guy named Atta, and all the kids in the entire school stay home for that particular day.
Now, which school was this?
This is, I don't remember the name, but it's back east someplace where you guys are.
Okay. When did you hear this story?
They had a big argument. Pardon me?
When did you hear the story?
Today.
You heard the story today. Where did you hear the story?
Matter of fact, I think you can, I can't remember. It might have been on Glenn Beck because he was the one that was saying that the Sharia law was of big concern because one of the things that Sharia law dictates is that if a woman goes out of the house by herself, they can throw rocks at her until she's dead. And that doesn't make sense. Who the hell are these people?
Obviously, that isn't going to. It just seems pretty unlikely that a group of people that present, you know, that they're less than 1% of the population, that they're not going to, that they're going to get away with something like this. What you're probably going to see over time is, as long as the problem in Europe, right, is that they're oftentimes giving these people some kind of welfare programs, enough to keep their family sort of afloat so that the lady doesn't have to work. Well, if you don't get these social welfare programs, everybody's got to go to work. When everybody goes to work, they tend to assimilate more. When the family assimilates, then the next generation, the girls are wearing jeans and the boys are, you know, hanging out at school or whatever. And by the third generation, they can't even speak their home language anymore. That's what's true. That's what's been true for immigrants up to this point, and likely that'll be the case here too.
I'd be real careful believing what you hear on talk radio in any case about Sharia law. There's a lot of people out there who really don't know what they're talking about. I did put a request out to the guys from Muslims for Liberty to have one of them call in about this, and hopefully we'll be able to hear from them tonight so they can clarify it. And I'm not going to go out on a limb and say that Sharia law is like some sort of humane system. I mean, any system of law tends to be inhumane in plenty of different ways. The American system of law is incredibly inhumane, and it imprisons, you know, a countless number of innocent people who've never harmed anybody else. So I'm not saying one system is necessarily better than the other. But Richard, in regards to your claim about the school, I did Google that one real quick, and I don't see any evidence for what you're saying here. There's a school in New Jersey which refused to shut down their school for an Islamic holiday.
Eid al-Adha. That's the name of the holiday here.
Yeah.
And dozens of Muslims crowded a school board meeting last Thursday, with many reportedly bussed in by CARE, which is some Muslim organization.
Now, I'd like to point out that I don't think they should shut down for any of the religious holidays out there.
I don't think
all.
They do.
Christmas?
No, that's winter holiday now. They don't call it Christmas anymore.
Okay, well, whatever.
It's not Christmas break. It's certainly traditionally Christmas, but, you know, nonetheless, that's what the idea is. Is I don't think they should have summer break either. The idea that you let kids go from school for 2.5 to 3 months, they forget everything. The teachers spend all this time, you know, catching back up.
And also, Richard, I think the other thing that's important to point out here is Muslims are a minority in the United States. They're not even close to being able to take over the government system.
They couldn't get this school to shut down one day. And by the way, they didn't have enough warning either. They were just like, hey, there's a day coming up soon. You should shut down for it.
So I don't think you really have anything to worry about here at all. Anything else you want to share tonight?
No, that's fine.
Thanks for the call.
Thanks.
I appreciate hearing from you. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733.
There's always going to be growing pains when any population begins to mix. I'm familiar. I remember the Benjamin Franklin quote where he's, and I don't remember the quote specifically, but he's complaining about the Amish. Now, these are the people that have
those Amish.
They have least assimilated of any of the population, right? Like, the Amish have least assimilated. You can say these people
God
have stuck to their
God bless them. I love them for that.
No, it doesn't matter to me one way or the
other.
I
don't agree with their religious viewpoint necessarily, but I like that they are steadfast.
They certainly stick to what they say, but he was complaining about them at that time, that they weren't, you know, fitting in or whatever, and somehow or another we made it past the big Amish threat. And the nation continues going. And, you know, I mean, you heard about it from the Italians, you heard about it from the Jews, and you heard about it from the Israelites, or not the Israelites, who's the Irish. You know, every time some new wave of immigrant comes in, it's a big problem while people assimilate to this new way of doing things. And then turns out there's more about them that we like than things that we don't like. And then, you know, we just keep going. Yeah, people think that that Muslims are different, or that Mexicans or South Americans are different, and they're not. They're just the immigrant of this time, and this is the growing pains that every nation that has allowed people to assimilate has always dealt with.
I have studied with Muslims. I've read the Quran myself when I was in jail. One of the guys in there was a Muslim, and he and I did some studying together. And
did you convert to Islam in prison? Because that'd be an awesome story. Like, that happens all the time.
No? I didn't. But you know, there are certainly reasons why people do that.
Can you just come up with a Muslim name instead? Just change your name to something Muslim-y. That would be fun.
I don't know how you would do that.
You don't know how you do that? You changed your name to something, to Ian B. Freeman.
Yeah, that's right. I don't know how you would change your name to something Muslim-y. I'm not sure exactly what
that happens.
That means.
You don't know what that means? Cassius Clay changed his name to Muhammad Ali. You don't know what I mean?
Well, I guess I could use the name Muhammad or something like that, but I don't know. I don't know.
Heard of these people?
I don't know the, I don't even know how to describe it. I'm not an English or Arabic expert, so I don't know how you describe the AL hyphen, the prefixes or suffixes, the Islamic suffix. I don't know anything about that, Mark. So, I know more about the Islamic religion than probably the average white guy in the United States.
Westerner.
Yeah, but I still am no expert. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Maybe you are an actual Muslim and you'd like to clarify Sharia law for us. This is Free Talk Live.
Okay, open your mouth and say ah.
Ah.
When your child has a sore throat, you need to know when to get help. The doctor-recommended Say-Ah Sore Throat Exam is your solution. The scientifically designed oral retractor offers a clear view of the throat, relaxing the tongue, and minimizing gag reflex. Compare with a medical-grade chart, website, and app. Then you'll know just what to tell your doctor. A wellness plan in your hands in minutes. Go to sayahnow.com. Sayahnow.com. The new mainstay for every family's first aid kit.
Paid non-attorney spokesperson, Adam Pulaski of the Pulaski Law Firm with principal office in Houston, Texas, is the attorney responsible for the content of this ad. This ad is not legal advice, and the choice of a lawyer should not be based solely upon advertisement. Services may not be available in all states.
Attention Xarelto users. If you or a loved one took Xarelto and suffered a serious bleeding event, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Xarelto is a popular prescription blood thinner used to prevent blood clots and protect patients from strokes. These serious bleeding events have led to numerous cases of hospitalization and even death. Phone lines are open 24/7. Call 800-261-0937. That's 800-261-0937.
Don't worry about things you can't control. Isn't that what they always say? But it's about impossible to avoid worrying about what's going on these days. The government has used the war on guns, the war on drugs, and the war on terrorism to tear our Bill of Rights to shreds. But you can fight back. The 10th Amendment Center has proven it, racking up major victories. For example, when the U.S. government claimed authority in the NDAA to have the military kidnap and detain Americans without trial, the nullifiers got a law passed in California, declaring the state's refusal to ever participate in any such thing. Their latest project is offnow.org, nullifying the National Security Agency. They've already gotten model legislation introduced in California, Arizona, Oklahoma, Missouri, and Kansas, meant to limit the power of the NSA to spy on Americans in those states. We'd be fools to wait around for the U.S. Congress or courts to roll back Big Brother. Our best chance is nullification and interposition on the state level. Go to offnow.org, print out that model legislation, and get to work nullifying the NSA. The hero Edward Snowden has risked everything to give us this chance. Let's take it. Offnow.org.
This is your Robertson Roberts Brokerage Daily Precious Metals Update. In early trading Monday, gold is $15 lower at $1,132 per ounce. Silver is down 50 cents at $14.66 per ounce. Bitcoin is trading at $237. This is a great time to buy on the dips. We have plenty of silver spiders, Britannias, and kangaroos in stock. Give us a call at 800-874-9760 or visit us online at rrbi.co.
LRN.fm is proud to announce our official listening apps for Android and iOS devices. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for LRN.fm in the Android or Apple app stores. Please download, rate it 5 stars, then share the link on social media, and let your friends and family know how you're listening to LRN.fm. Download it now, free, at apps.lrn.fm. That's apps.lrn.fm.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at shiresociety.com. That's shiresociety.com.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at lrn.fm.
Speaking of Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, you were talking about Muslim names, Mark, earlier, picking a new name for oneself. He's got a few comments about Sharia law and the common misconceptions, in at least in America, among right-wing talk show hosts and their listeners about Sharia law. I'm sure left-wing talk show hosts and their listeners are probably as ignorant. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And it doesn't matter what your religion is, so long as you can take delivery from Amazon wherever you are in the world. If you can order Amazon to your location, if they can deliver to where you live, you qualify to go to saveitpurse.com and save 20%, maybe even more, on your purchases at Amazon. The catch is, you got to use Bitcoin. If you don't have Bitcoin, you can't get these deep discounts. Bitcoin is a decentralized currency created by the internet, basically. It wasn't created by any government or any bank. Bitcoin's amazing. You can learn more about Bitcoin at bitcoin.com. And you don't need Bitcoin to go to saveitpurse.com to learn about it or to open an account. But you will need Bitcoin if you actually do want to save 20% or more on Amazon. I do it all the time. I've got two orders in right now that I'm waiting to receive. You do have to have some patience if you want to save 20% or more. You place an order for 20% off your products at Amazon, it might take a couple hours to fulfill that order. If you place it at, let's say, 40% off, you may be waiting a few days before somebody purchases it. And there's no guarantee that someone's going to purchase it at 40% off, but the average discount in the United States is 20% off. So if you go for 20% off, it's almost a guarantee that it's going to sell. It's awesome. And it works really well. You get the stuff you want from Amazon at huge, deep discounts when you start at saveatpurse.com. That's saveatpurse.com. As we continue here, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar interviewed on the Fox News Channel discussing comments by a Dr. Ben Carson, who I understand is one of the presidential candidates.
Yeah, a recent poll came out. He was tied with Trump.
Where he said, oh, did you hear, by the way, that Trump wants universal health care?
Yeah, yep. I knew that already. That was something that he'd come out with previously.
I just saw the headline on it today.
I just think it's interesting that Republicans, who are regularly called racist by the Democrats, have their, you know, their front runner at this point. If he's tied, if they're tied, right? Like one of them's they're both front runners. Their front runner is black, and this happened previously with Herman Cain too. I just think it's interesting that the Democrats are always tossing out the race card against the Republicans on this, and you know, clearly it's not entirely true.
So apparently, this Ben Carson said something about he doesn't think a Muslim should be president. With he said this in an interview with Kareem Abdul-Jabbar. Abdul-Jabbar said Sharia law does not condone rape or murder, and then Fox News Channel hosts Maria Baritromo said, quote, "We know that Sharia law means killing homosexuals. Women are subservient to men. Tell me about Sharia law," unquote. And Kareem said, Islam does not okay the things that you just mentioned, killing people, rape, all of these things that have been associated now with Sharia law. That's crazy. None of the people that have that criticism of Sharia law have checked out the law, because it's not even for non-Muslims. Sharia law is for ruling an Islamic state. So Sharia law could never apply here in America, because America is a very diverse place. They got it all wrong. They don't know what the law states, actually. They want to distort it to make Muslims the villain," unquote. I'd say he nailed it. That's absolutely what's going on here. These poor Muslims are being painted with an incredibly negative brush by people in the mainstream media, by these talk show hosts, by these presidential candidates. And that's because they want to have a boogeyman out there. They want to have something that's scary out there for people, because the government needs to have something that they can protect you from, ostensibly. Right. And the Muslims are the new threat, supposedly.
If there isn't somebody on the other side, then they can't be on your side. right? Right. They find a small percentage of the population. In this case, they Muslims less than 1%, illegal aliens less than 1%, and they make them look all bad, and then have you, hey, look at all the threats that these people are to you and your way of life, and not so much. I don't think I haven't felt threatened.
No, the Muslims have fed me. They've helped me. I appreciate the things that my Muslim friends have done. And they've always been peaceful, and they've always advocated for peace. And
the government, on the other hand, demands that you give them something like a third to, well, depending on your situation, a third to two-thirds of your money, and then regulates be able to do business for yourself. The government is a gigantic threat to you. And these folks from other countries or whatever, they're not.
Exactly. Let's talk to Judge Rudy, calling from Concord, New Hampshire. You're on Free Talk Live, Judge Rudy.
If Kareem Abdul-Jabbar was telling the absolute truth, he would say...
Is he a big fat liar?
Sharia law, if I may continue, Sharia law means what it means, depending on where you live. There are places where what Dr. Ben Carson was alluding to, the Stone Age Romeos rule the world, and Sharia law is pretty, well, again. But anyway, I'm relieved, by the way, Ian, for the free citizens of Keene are safe from your nicest activist tool being a completely innocent, unintended target of one of your flaming freedoms lover, Derrick Horton's gun. If he was a gun toter in your town, I think there's more of a chance he'd hit an innocent person anybody he was trying to defend himself.
You must be
from.
Not paying close attention to what we said. Derrick J. has not been prohibited from having a gun. He's just not allowed to conceal carry
weapons.
It.
I know. The point carries for both concealed and unconcealed weapons. The little what he is, I think there's more a much bigger chance that somebody that's completely innocent would be shot by him than somebody that he was wanting to hurt in defense of himself because he's
What do
Not
you base a, the idea that Derrick J. Freeman, who is a peaceful individual...
Anyway, Matt, I have nothing
We're having a conversation, right?
I have nothing against Derrick Horton, by the way.
Well, what apparently do you do. You think he's going to shoot innocent people. Why?
Because I think he'll make like Fredo, like I've said before, when he gets out of that car to defend his dad, and will drop the gun rather than shooting the guys that are shooting his dad. But that's just an allusion to a...
I have no idea what you're talking about. Thanks for the call tonight. And don't lie about your name to get on the air here. You can give your real name. I'm not saying you have to, but that guy that called, his name is James in Arizona. He's not in Concord, New Hampshire, and his name is certainly not Judge Rudy. And I don't care if you use a fake name to get on the air, but if we know who you are, it's not there's no point in lying about it. It's not like we're not going to take your phone call.
I've kept him off the air in the past, so that's probably what he's trying to do is to avoid being kept off the air.
You're not in charge of the show tonight.
No, I am not behind the
I will
thing.
Take anyone's call. This is Free Talk Live, and I don't think you should be keeping people off the air, Mark. I disagree with that, and you shouldn't be doing that on Free Talk Live.
I find his threatening me and my family on a relatively regular basis to be disturbing.
Well, he kind of beats around the bush. He doesn't usually...
I've got a whole page, things James Winnikind says. You can go there and see exactly how much he beats around the bush.
Yeah, I personally don't feel like he actually comes right out and threatens people.
He has done it a few times.
He has? Okay.
You're going to regret. That's not a threat?
That's not a threat. That's just saying you're going to regret something.
Yeah. I'm going to wipe that smile off your face.
You could do that with words.
I'm going to come there and make you regret.
You could do that with words or with actions that don't actually
harm. How is he going to make me regret that by coming here?
Well, obviously he can't control whether you regret things or not. That's
no,
up
he
to
can't.
You to decide. So the toll-free number tonight, if you
it's
want to join
threat,
us here,
Ian.
855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can absolutely bring up anything that you want to discuss here, whether it's Sharia law or something else completely different. You know, I wanted to talk about the Venezuela story, but we'll have to do that another night. It's a little bit detailed. It's about Nicolas Maduro and the Daily Beast asking, has he gone insane? But let's go to Skype where Justin Biebs is on the line. Justin, you're on Free Talk Live. Hello? Going once, going twice. He hung up.
Just after you tell, you say that people can't use a fake name on the air, whatever, you tell him not to lie about his name, then Justin Biebs calls in, right?
Yeah, Justin was trying to call in earlier. Yep. Toll-free number is 855.
Obviously, it's not Justin Beeps.
450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Well, like I said, we don't require that you use a real name to call the show. But we do require that you actually talk when we put you on the air. Otherwise, you're going to get banned. It's Free Talk Live, and I think that guy's actually tried to call in under a different name before. Free Talk Live. Bring up anything.
As a pioneer of the e-commerce movement, Overstock.com is proud to be the first major retailer to accept Bitcoin. Overstock was the first because Patrick Byrne, Overstock's CEO and founder, firmly believes in personal freedom and cryptocurrency. Over the past 16 years, Overstock has furnished over 18 million homes with a diverse line of products to suit everyone's unique styles and preferences. Support Overstock and freedom of choice while enjoying free shipping on orders of 0.211 Bitcoin or more.
Know what's always on my mind, kid? Safety. I live, eat, and breathe safety. When I wake up in the morning, I have a large cup of safety with two sugars and a dash of safety. Safety matters. Your safety, my safety, everybody's safety. That's why I love Grainger. Grainger has the products, services, and resources to help keep our facility safe and our people safer. Now pass me one of those safety donuts over there. Call clickgrainger.com/safety or stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
Wait a minute. Don't spend a dime on emergency food storage until you visit ReadySupplyFoods.com. If you're interested in getting the most high-quality food for your money, then see our comparison page where we list all the companies and rank them by value for your dollar. You'll see that Ready Supply Foods sells 50% more food for your money than any other company. GMO-free, 25-year shelf life, great tasting, and free shipping. Make an informed decision by going to ReadySupplyFood.com today.
Hey, Berkey Guy here. Are you still drinking unfiltered tap water? Does your water contain chlorine or fluoride? Will you have drinkable water in an emergency? The Berkey Guy is here to help you remove these and other potential contaminants from your water, thus helping you drink clean, purified water. We offer Berkey water purification systems at the lowest available prices online. Don't go another moment without Berkey system. Over the last 10 years, we've helped thousands drink clean, purified water. Join them by visiting GoBerkey.com or call me, the Berkey Guy, at 877-886-3653. That's 877-886-3653.
Keenvention is coming up fast, October 30th through November 1st. Get your tickets now at keenvention.info. Keenvention is an intimate event where you can meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire, including Oathkeeper Chris Reitman, Libertarian presidential candidate Daryl W. Perry, illegal Uber driver Christopher David, NeoCash Radio's Dr. Darren Tapp, State Representative Mike Sylvia, rated an A+ by the NHLA, The Seditious Sirens, The Rebel Love Show's Rob Mathias, tech guru Brian Sovereign, cop blocker J.P. Freeman, new mover Dr. Taryn Lupo, longtime political activist Dennis Goddard, Church of the Invisible Hand minister Rich Paul, Shire Dude, and dozens more. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or with Bitcoin. That includes access to the Hallowkeen costume dance party. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more speaker announcements or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate.
Oof, I think we've all had enough of that jingle, don't you? If you're going to invest in property in New Hampshire, it just makes sense to support a liberty-friendly realtor. Call Mark Warden of Team Porcupine Real Estate for investment property or rentals in the free state, or visit his website. Come on, you know it.
PorcupineRealEstate.com.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
Yeah! It's Free Talk Live. You're invited to join us here toll-free. 855-450-FREE. In the remaining moments, we have enough time for you at 855-450-3733. Also, Skype in to the show. Username LRN.FM with you in studio tonight. It's Ian.
And Mark.
And, of course, you can join us at Keenvention. Coming up here in about four and a half weeks, something like that. It's the end of October, October 30th through November 1st. That's right. It's Halloween weekend. A great opportunity to come up to New Hampshire and check out this place with these wonderful people that we talk about so frequently here on Free Talk Live, the Free State Project. Check it out during the fall. There are no official Free State Project events during the fall, so we created one that is an unofficial event. It is not put on by the Free State Project. It is put on by me and the Shire Free Church and freekeen.com. And Mark Warden, who's helping out with sponsorship this year, as he has the last 2 years. So the Porcupine Realtor is on board as well, or the Porcupine Real Estate Agent, I should say. And there will be dozens of Liberty activists from across the Shire who are going to be speaking at this event. There'll be about 11 panels that will be up there on the stage. There'll be three keynote speakers, including the illegal Uber driver.
Oh, good.
This is our newest announcement. I haven't actually made the announcement yet anywhere but Free Talk Live. It's coming to keenvention.info soon. I just wanted to get a few more of the panels out there first. Christopher David, the Uber driver who has come out and has announced publicly that he is engaging in civil disobedience, that he is picking up people as an Uber driver in Portsmouth, New Hampshire, where it is not legal to do that. He is violating the law and facing fines of up to $1,000 a day in order to take someone from point A to point B on a consensual basis. I think this guy's a hero, and he absolutely deserves to be a keynote speaker at Keenvention. Also, our very own Daryl W. Perry is going to be keynote speaking, as well as Chris Reitman, both of whom are hosts here on Free Talk Live. So it's kind of like a Free Talk Live convention in some ways, in that a lot of our co-hosts end up on stage during the event.
They're movers.
Black Sheep Rising, our friend Conan, is going to be doing his show there live at Keenvention. So that's going to be a first. Because, Mark, you and I, we don't bring Free Talk Live to Keenvention because we're already in town. And, like, why bother moving all the equipment across town just to do a show from a hotel? But they're actually going to be doing Black Sheep Rising, which is a TV show, in the Keenvention Hall during one of the lunches this year. So that's
right.
Cool. So lots of stuff happening. You can go to keenvention.info. You can get your tickets for $60 or Bitcoin. It's October 30th through November 1st, and it's a great excuse to come up and meet some of the activists you hear so much about here on Free Talk Live and over at LRN.FM. It's a great opportunity to do that, explore the area, maybe get out, do some social events like the Bonfire or Halloween's Costume Dance Party, and more. Go and learn more about the event at keenvention.info. You know, there was a piece over at the Advocates for Self-Government that I thought was a good one from their Liberator Online about activism. And I'm an activist. And if you care about the world around you, then you should be an activist too, especially if you love liberty. If you love the state, then just go ahead and keep watching TV and stay very distracted. But if you love liberty, then you really ought to do some real life activism. I'm not talking about Facebook. And that's what Brett Bittner, who's the new head of the Advocates for Self-Government, is talking about here. He's the new president over there. He writes in his article headlining the recent, they've got a weekly newsletter that goes out called The Liberator Online, called Slacktivism, You Can Do More. He says, I've worn ribbons, I've liked, shared, favorited, retweeted, and pinned things on social media. I've sported a sticker on my laptop. But did any of that really accomplish anything? When looking at the direct effect of those activities, there was no measurable impact. So why bother with what I call slacktivism? And he says he'll answer that shortly. But where is there a measurable impact? And he gives some suggestions for things that you could get involved in wherever you are. You don't have to be in New Hampshire to be an activist. You can do it anywhere. Tabling and outreach booth. And this is what I kind of cut my teeth on doing
activism. You sure did.
Setting up a table at an existing event and meeting new people is a great way to find new people for your group, your issue, or your philosophy.
Do you think it's worth the cost? Because in a lot of times, it's hundreds of dollars to get a booth at many of these events. And Ian, I know that you essentially funded this for the Libertarian Party of Sarasota.
I did.
Where you got a lot of it. And in many cases, I don't... I don't know what your results are. You essentially got two activists that I know about involved, and one of which has moved for the Free State Project and then kind of has moved away, and another that is still quite involved. So, you know, I mean, it seems like...
Well, I reached thousands of people with the ideas of freedom.
You did? With what, though? Okay. And with the ideas of freedom? Okay.
Yeah. That's worth something to me.
It's worth something.
You know, how else are you going to do it? How else is the average person going to reach people? Obviously, we have a radio show, so
they
we can
donate to the Amplifier program and probably use their $500 per year in booth money more effectively.
Yeah, I mean, that's a nice idea, Mark, but it's not going to grow their local group. It's not going to getting on Free Talk Live.
How many
Live.
People did you get on to grow your local group with these tabling events you had? How many people went to your events at in the sum total of all the tabling events?
That wasn't
events?
The goal of the outreach. The
okay,
goal
but
of the
said
outreach.
That that's what it was for this other.
What now?
Well, you'd said that how else are they going to grow their local group?
Yeah, and I'm that pointing was their out, goal.
It wasn't effective when you did it.
That wasn't my goal.
It wasn't your goal? I mean, you're paying for a booth for the Libertarian Party of Sarasota, and your goal isn't to get people to go to the Libertarian Party of Sarasota. I recall you had actually ballot registration things there, too, trying to get people to register
That's
Libertarian.
Right. Sure. We did that.
Okay.
But the goal was to, you know, introduce people to the ideas of liberty. Now, it'd be nice if some people showed up for a meeting, but I'm not unrealistic. I know how boring political meetings are. People don't want to go to that crap. So
it's boring.
You know, I can't blame them for that. But yeah, I mean, as far as reaching out to people in your local area, then there's nothing as effective as getting out in front of them. And you can post all the crap you want on Facebook. Nobody cares about that stuff. It's just, it's ephemeral. It scrolls past your newsfeed, poof, and then it's gone, and you never see it again.
I think that it shows support. It's like a yard sign for a politician. So if a politician is getting a lot of, if one politician's getting a lot of play on Facebook, then that can be meaningful to people. They can feel like they have support.
Who cares?
Okay.
Facebook is, it's just... I'm so sick of Facebook. I wish I didn't have to spend time on it, but I feel like I'm obligated to because business and because that's where people are. But ultimately, I think Facebook is counterproductive for activism. I don't think it actually creates more activism than it kills. I think it kills more activism than it sparks.
Okay.
But going on here, as Brett Bittner points out on his article, setting up a table at an existing event is a great way to find new people for your group, issue, or philosophy. When you're in college, there's always an opportunity to table. Once you're out, however, it gets pricier and a bit more difficult, but it can be done. Gun shows, book fairs, holiday festivals, and town celebrations are a prime opportunity to reach out to the local community for the post-college readers.
I also think that, you know, when you're talking about college and high school and these sorts of things, they intend to get you involved in communities. So for the libertarian types to have their own communities to get people involved, it's a good idea rather than sort of fitting, you know, taking your, you know, having your round peg square pounded into their square hole. Go ahead and do your own thing there.
And just because you're doing an outreach booth doesn't mean you can't outreach in other ways. So, for instance, the local college here has some stupid rules about what you have to do an outreach booth. Or you can set up a table as a non-college student, but you have to follow the same dumb rules that the college students have to follow, which includes you can't speak outside of the table, basically. Like, okay, if you were walking by as a college student, Mark, and I was sitting at a table, I couldn't say, hey, come on over, let's talk about this. You know, whatever the issue might happen to be.
Yeah.
That is forbidden. So I don't jump through their hoops. I'll just show up on the college campus with a stack of flyers and then hand them out in 10 minutes and leave. Because to me, that's more effective than sitting quietly behind a table and not being able to talk to people. So going door to door, he says, while it sounds like a strictly candidate or party politics activity, can be something that gets noticed by your neighbors. If you're active in your community or highly visible, this kind of activism can lead to growth as you ask those around you to join your efforts. And then he goes on to talk about contributions. And of course, you mentioned that, Mark, contributing to the Free Talk Live AMP program is certainly something that you can do, and that'll have a tangible effect.
Pew, pew, pew.
Oh, there's someone
that?
There. He's apparently it's Brian who is making silly noises
yes.
into his microphone.
Oh, I was just seeing if I was going to come on before the end of the show. My apologies, guys. Mark, I just had a quick question for you. I wanted to open up a big topic, but I wanted to ask you, since you raised pigs, did you say that humans, I heard this from Nathan from Texas, that you think that the evidence that we are carnivores is because we have canine teeth?
I think canine teeth is pretty good evidence that we're carnivores. Sure. I mean, isn't that the purpose of them, to hold prey?
That's what I dispute. I don't think that these canine teeth that we have are designed for tearing through flesh, because I'm not sure if you tried using them, but you can't really go through fish scales, never mind hard skin of a big cow.
I wish we had more time for it, Brian.
It's not to go through, it's to hold.
But we're out of it for now. But if you want to re-initiate this discussion, tomorrow night would be a fine time for it at the beginning of the show.
They're not the best canines.
In the meantime, freetalklive.com.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
Are you tired of governments murdering people around the world? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless free market non-political currency. Bitcoin cannot be inflated or controlled by any government. By using their money, you are helping the state. Stop doing it. You have an incredible alternative available now. Learn it, use it, spread it. Get started with Bitcoin at bitcoin.com. That's bitcoin.com.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
The latest episode of Liberty Conspiracy is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
From Keenan, the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Monday, September 28th, 2015. Silver is trading at $14.70 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,132 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $238. Antiwar.com reports early reports of the Islamic State trying to establish an affiliate in Afghanistan were mostly downplayed by the U.S. and other Western powers, who believed the group to be little more than a handful of disaffiliated Taliban commanders trying to get international attention. That the rare the Islamic State activity was all fighting against the Taliban rivals seemed to support that. Sunday, the Islamic State gunmen attacked a police checkpoint in Nangarhar, killing 3 and wounding 8 in the first real attack against the Afghan security force. The attack comes amid reports of a growing the Islamic State influence across the nation and a huge recruitment effort spanning 25 provinces. Indeed, the latest report suggests that only about 10% of the Islamic State force inside Afghanistan is Taliban defectors, and that the group's parent organization in Iraq and Syria has sent roughly 70 seasoned commanders to serve as the leadership core of this growing branch. The ability to recruit Taliban defectors might be growing with the latest leadership disputes in that group, but the ability of the Islamic State to form an almost entirely new group with so little crossover with a Taliban insurgency that's been in place for decades suggests they are resonating with a whole new group of people and could be a hugely complicating matter in the ongoing occupation of Afghanistan.
For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. UPI reports President Obama and Raul Castro will meet Tuesday at the United Nations to discuss the developing relationship between the United States and Cuba. In Cuba's first UN General Assembly since the two countries renewed diplomatic relations, the White House said Obama will hold a bilateral meeting with Castro. This is the second face-to-face between Obama and Castro since diplomatic relations were restored in late 2014. They also met in April at the Summit of the Americas meeting in Panama and have spoken by phone. Ben Rhodes, Obama's Deputy National Security Advisor for Strategic Communications, called Castro's UN visit very significant and a symbol we're in a new era of U.S.-Cuba relations. On Friday, he met with several members of Congress who support the renewed relations. While at the United Nations, Obama will meet with the President of Kazakhstan, Prime Minister of India, and possibly Vladimir Putin to discuss topics that include concerns about a Russian military buildup in Syria.
Are you an advocate for free market money? Do you promote Bitcoin as an alternative in a fiat-centric world? Then you need Spendabit in your arsenal, the search engine for things you can buy with Bitcoin. Spendabit aggregates millions of products from thousands of Bitcoin-enabled merchants. Keep your money in the free economy. Visit spendabit.co today. Bitcoin merchants, ask about our merchant suite to reach even more customers. Spendabit.co.
Reuters reports separatists on Sunday won a clear majority of seats in Catalonia's parliament in an election that sets the region on a collision course with Spain's central government over independence. With secessionist parties securing 72 out of 135 seats in the region of 7.5 million people that includes Barcelona, acting regional government head Artur Mas told reporters Catalans have voted yes to independence. The strong pro-independence showing dealt a blow to Spanish Prime Minister Mariano Rajoy 3 months before a national election. His center-right government, which has opposed attempts to hold a referendum on secession, has called the separatist plan a nonsense and vowed to block it in court. The main secessionist group, Together for Yes, won 62 seats, while the smaller leftist CUP party earned 10 seats. Both had said before the vote that such a result would allow them to unilaterally declare independence within 18 months, under a plan that would see the new Catalan authorities approving their own constitution and building institutions like an army, central bank, and judicial system. Mas said a democratic mandate now exists to move forward with independence. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Americans across the nation made their voices heard this week as they demanded more mind-blowing guitar solos. Calling for the solos to be, quote, face-meltingly cool and go on for well over 10 minutes, Americans stressed that all guitar solos from now on should be equally as kick-ass as those in Van Halen's Hot for Teacher and AC/DC's Thunderstruck, or even better.
It should start out really slow, you know, and then get faster and faster until they're all the way up at the top of the guitar neck and bending the notes like crazy, so it's like, and then there's all this awesome pyrotechnic stuff going off in the background. They should all be like that.
And in this week's local news, a report noted that on its surface, Glenbrook, Ohio is a small town like any other, a peaceful, all-American town. And yet, the report's authors added, if you only look closer, what you find may surprise you. In other news, a man is just having one of those decades where he doesn't feel like doing anything.
This is the Onion News Network.
And this is Liberty Conspiracy Radio on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM if you're streaming us over the airwaves.